SEC, Kevin, top to bottom, extremely tough.
And no question, the most competitive conference in the entire nation.
Here they come, the Tigers of Auburn, led on by head coach Pat Dodd. A lot of controversy on this campus this week, but the squad has put it all behind them, and the fans, there are 85,000 here on a Saturday night. It becomes the fifth largest city in the state of Alabama. They don't care, because the Gators are the opponent. It's Halloween night. Who'll get the trick and who'll get the treat? ESPN's live presentation of CFA football is being brought to you by the U.S. Armed Forces. It's a great place to start. By the people of Rockwell International, where science gets down to business. By the makers of the CFA VCR College Bowl game. And by Budweiser. Beat Good Ames for that clean, crisp taste. This was for you.
Company, but what
team schedule? Teams have three SEC games plus a date with fourth ranked Florida State remaining on their schedule. Traditionally, Florida has an off date, an open date before their game with Auburn. They use those 14 days to get their injured players healthy and get their team ready to play against one of the toughest programs in the nation, the Auburn Tigers. Well, Auburn's coach Pat Dye doesn't like playing at a disadvantage to Florida, so what he's done, he has not practiced his team in pads but once over the past 2 weeks. The result, to get his team ready to play the great Florida Gator team. Get them healthy, get them pumped up. This is one of the most fierce rivalries in the nation. It's endured over the years, and preparations begin long before the opening kickoff. Jim?
All right, partner. We talked about it being the 64th meeting. Auburn leads the series with 34 wins. Florida has won 27 times. There have been two times, but the Gators have won the last three meetings. Florida won the toss. They have deferred. They want to kick off to start the game. They'll take the football to start the second half. There is Robert McGinty. He used to be a place kicker here at Auburn University. Back deep, number 25, Harry Mose. And we are just about set to get underway. A great rivalry in the SEC, and will have major impact on all the bowl games. There are seven bowl scouts here. It is high, it is deep, it is end over end. It's Mose at the one. Upended at the 18-yard line. Now let's watch the sophomore quarterback, Reggie Slack. There he is, out of Milton, Florida, 6'1", 204 pounds. He's only thrown 17 passes last week, completed 11, 29 on the season. He does have three touchdowns. Reggie will take the first snap, and then Jeff Berger will come in. In the backfield, he'll work with Stacy Danley, the freshman out of Winston, Georgia. Reggie Ware, the senior from Huntsville, Alabama. Tillman and Donaldson are the wide receivers. Loose football, and Reggie Slack falls on it for a loss of two. Second down and 12. Now, head coach Pat Dye said that Reggie Slack would just take the one snap. He told Reggie on Thursday afternoon he had a meeting with quarterback Jeff Berger, with Pat Dye, with Pat Sullivan, and the four of them talked it over. Pat Dye said, Reggie, it's not that I don't have confidence in you, because I do. Your time will come, but this is Berger's game to win or to lose. Then they told the squad. So Berger in there for the second snap on second down and a long 11. Motion by Donaldson. Berger will go airborne. Needs 11 over the middle. Safety valves out at the 20-yard line. He's got Walter Reeves. You've met Jeff Berger. Let's meet the rest of the Auburn offense.
Jimmy, Pat Dye going with the freshman Danley for speed at tailback starting tonight. Receivers, Tillman is the superstar, but as a group, they're as good as any you'll see. Searles, the safety, an excellent, a tackle, is an excellent player, the top player on the offensive line. Rest of the line, a little bit small, maybe suspect.
Tillman, Donaldson, and Wright are the wide receivers. Danley, the lone running back, as Berger bends in. Looks to the sideline. Got his man at the 32-yard line. Lawyer Tillman, the junior out of Mobile. Ricky Mulberry on the coverage.
Well, that's about the best thing that could have happened for Auburn, having Berger come into the game. It's man-to-man coverage, and Berger right on the mark to Tillman. That ball hits him right in the chest. And a first down for Auburn right off the bat.
First down of the ball game. The ball resting just shy of the 32-yard line as Tillman checks out. Out of the I pro set. Where is the fullback? And the tailback is Danley. Danley with the ball. Cracks it over the left side. nothing doing as Todd Gatlin, number 48, the junior from Fort Walton, Florida, made the stop. Let's meet the rest of the Gators.
These guys are thin, but they're tough. Roth has a little bit of an ankle injury. Weston, as I said earlier, playing with a broken jaw. Reuter is playing. He's an excellent linebacker. Clifford Charlton, one of the best in the country. The inside backers, Dickens, the leading tackler. Gatlin back after an injury. Mulberry, Watkins, good corners. Secondary, the strength right here. Williams and Oliver, the two safeties, are outstanding players.
Berger needs 11, finds a man open over the middle up near the 38-yard line. That's the tight end, Walter Reeves, 6'4", 247 pounds, redshirted back in 84. He's a junior. There is Rondy Weston. He's playing with a broken jaw. How does that affect your concentration?
Well, I was a defensive player at times, and I don't know how anybody could play with a broken jaw. You're looking at the helmet, the big cage, but that cage is used by a lot of players under normal circumstances. The part over the ear hole, I think, is... See, you see it over the ear hole? I think they're using that to stabilize the jaw area, but if he gets his head in there, it's going to be a shock.
Blitz is on. Berger tries to pick it up, finds a man out of the backfield at the 43. That's Duke Donaldson, the senior from Cairo, Georgia. Berger, 4 for 4.
Thing about Donaldson, he runs precise routes. Now, this is a blitz, Jim. You called it. They have to dump the ball quick. Donaldson will break it off. Berger takes not a deep drop. See, here it is, almost a little bit of a pick there. Right on the money. A good pattern, a good throw. Great recognition by the quarterback and the receiver.
Berger, 4 for 4, 27 yards. The ball at the 43-yard line. Reeves, the tight end. Tillman and Wright are wideouts to the top of your screen. Berger pitches back. Danley dives across the 45-yard line, blocking on that left side by Eric Floyd and Stacy Dunn. There is Danley and what he has done so far this season. The freshman out of Winston, Georgia. Rondy Weston checks back in. Now he checks out. Pat Pinner is in now at the right defensive tackle for the Florida Gators. Second and 8, the ball at the 45.
Weston got hooked on that last play. That's why they took him out.
Pressure, Berger, incomplete at the 48-yard line. Reeves, and the ball might have been tipped by Pinner, who just came in, the 6'3 senior out of Lakeland, Florida.
Florida opened this game in man-to-man coverage, and Berger ate him up. Now, that was the first time the secondary asserted itself. He had plenty of time, but people were covered. By the time he got that ball off, he was running in the wrong direction, had to throw it going to his left. Good job by the Florida secondary.
Berger now 4 out of 5, 27 yards, but they've been perfect on third down conversions. Now they need 8. Is wide open. Berger looks downfield, and it is incomplete at the 34. And the Auburn fans are saying, where's the flag? Alexander Wright thought he was interfered with, but great coverage by Lewis Oliver.
They want to call on number 18, Lewis Oliver, but what you're going to see here is unbelievable athletic ability. Look at him jump and reach with his right hand over the receiver, over Wright, without apparently interfering with him. A great play.
Brian Schulman will kick. Jarvis Williams, explosive, averages about 14 yards on the punt returns. Loose football inside the 20, and the Gators get it back. Let's meet the Florida offense.
Kerwin Bell, not a Heisman candidate anymore, but one of the great players in college football, Emmitt Smith. He's taken over in the Heisman race. They've got to stop him tonight if they're going to stop the offense. The receivers may be suspect. Stacey Simmons, the best of the three. David Williams, a great offensive tackle, and the line is happy because they're blocking for one of the best backs in the entire country, the young freshman.
85,000. They make some noise. Bell backpedals, sets up, wants it all, looks downfield, blocked at the 40 by Ernie Mills. What a way to open up for the Gators. Mills was open. Bell put it right on the money.
This has been a problem for Florida the entire year. Their receivers don't catch the ball. Mills, 5 catches, 124 yards. Great average, but only 5 catches, and that's why they beat the secondary. Kerwin, as he has been most of the year on target, the ball is dropped. But they stretch it vertically, makes Auburn think about it.
Second and 10 from the 20. Emmett Smith. Let's meet the Auburn defense.
And you'd hate to meet these guys in an alley. One of the best front threes you'll find. Rocker, Roland, and Hill, all superior players, excellent players. The outside backers led by Andre Bruce, big play guy. Kurt Crane, a walk-on, now an all-SEC player, just a great player. The corners, excellent players, very heady, and the two safeties are hitters. Staples has 4 interceptions. This is a great defense. They give up just over 9 points a game.
They'll have to be great if they hope to slow down Emmett Smith. You just can't stop him. All you can do is slow him down. He picked up 5 on that last carry. 3rd and 5. Bell backpedals. Sideline. Incomplete and almost intercepted at the 38-yard line. Kevin Porter, 5'11". If he had another couple of inches, that would have been an interception. The senior out of Warner Robins, Georgia, bats it down. 3 plays and a punt for the Gators. There is Jamie McAndrew. Averages just under 40 yards a punt. A great record inside the 20. And back deep, Duke Donaldson, who also doubles as a wide receiver for Pat Dodd. We've played 5 minutes, and it's scoreless. Beautiful spiral kick. Backs Donaldson up to the 29. Slips and falls down at the 33. A 46-yard punt, a 4-yard return. We're scoreless in the SEC, the Tigers and the Gators.
Jeep design.
Their feet. Presentation of CFA football brought to you by Jeep. There's a feeling you can get only in a Jeep. And by the financial professionals at Payne Weber Incorporated. Along with Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, and happy Halloween from all of us at ESPN. Berger now hit his first 4 tries, 27 yards. They've tried to set up the screen, incomplete. Berger wisely throws it out of bounds. And that's one of the things Pat Dye was talking about. He said he wanted to be fair to Reggie, but this has to be Jeff Berger's game to win or lose. You just can't replace experience, and that's what Berger has.
That's an excellent observation, and what you saw there was an incomplete pass. Most people would say, well, we'll try again next down. Slack would not have made that play. He recognized Berger did. The screen was covered. Throws it out of bounds. They get a shot at another play without an interception. Good play.
Scott Bolton wide to the top of your screen. Donaldson in motion. The fullback, Reggie Ware, goes absolutely nowhere. The middle of that Florida front, led by Webby Burnett and Mark Seeger, penetrated. And it brings up 3rd and long.
When Auburn began the year, they had guards that were inexperienced. Ware is a short yardage guy, only averages 2.9 yards a carry. This is not a great running team, and it is an excellent rushing defense for Florida. As I said, thin depth, a little bit of a problem for Florida. If they get key injuries, they'll be in trouble. But their frontline guys, as you just saw, are very tough against the run. And the Tigers believe they have to run in this game to win.
Auburn 2 for 3 on 3rd down conversions. They need 9. The sack coming from behind by Clifford Charlton, who causes a team, Kevin, to rearrange their offensive thinking. He almost takes away half the field.
70% of the time, Jim, they double-team this guy. 40% of the time, they like to run away from him. What you're going to see is athletic ability. Now, Berger has plenty of time to throw, but the combination of the secondary and this guy getting off the block make for a sack.
Jarvis Williams back deep. Kuhlman second punt. He hangs it high. It's a beauty. Fair catch called for at the 18-yard line. A 50-yard punt. There was no return. 8:29 to go. We're scoreless at Auburn. 8:29 left to go in a scoreless first quarter. And Kevin, they just announced to the 85,000 plus. This is the largest crowd to ever see a college football game in the state of Alabama, and there have been some great games.
Well, I can attest to it. It's a very large crowd.
And loud.
And loud.
Bell gives off. Loose football again, and Auburn's got it. Tracy Rocker falls on the loose football. Two freshmen in the backfield, Smith and McGrady. And Rocker, number 74, comes up with a second turnover.
We talked about the strength of that front three and maturity of the front three and the strength. Remember the freshman Smith, he's got the ball. Somebody, I believe, gets an arm in there. Rocker knocks it out. And with age and maturity comes a lot of arm strength. Watch number 74. This guy's a horse. He takes one swipe at it as Emmett's going by, and it's Auburn's ball. Only seven fumbles for Florida up to that point this season. Seven lost fumbles.
From the 22, pitch back to Stacy Danley. Tries the right side with blocking by Hudson, Garner, and Searles. Well, you can see what Auburn has done, leading the nation with a plus 15 turnover ratio. And boy, was Pat Dye aware of that at practice last night. Talked about one of the things that the Tigers must do defensively is create some turnovers, because Florida is so very explosive offensively.
Well, they have second in the nation. They have 16 interceptions, the Auburn defense. That was a fumble.
Rondi Weston checks back in for the Gators. Motion by Donaldson. Mix up in the backfield. Loose football. But the Tigers get it back. Berger falls on the ball. I think it was Todd Gatlin, 48, that caused the loose football. There's Pat Dye in his seventh year. Has a little touch of the intestinal flu. Ran a temperature of about 101 today and was given a shot this morning about 11 o'clock. Feeling much better at kickoff, we are told. Went out to his farm to relax a little bit yesterday, clear his head. Said he was going horseback riding, but I asked him last night if he rode, and he said no, just worked on the tractor a little bit.
Keep an eye on number 85, Tillman. He's very tall, playing against a shorter player. They like the loft to him.
Fake to Danley. Berger fires. Caught inside the 10. Diving to the 5 is Royer Tillman. A 17-yard pickup. First and goal coming up.
Guy 6'4", 224 pounds, junior wide receiver. You can see the difference in the size there. Defensive back goes down. It's no contest. Berger right on the mark. Here comes Charlton, and here comes Stacy Searles, one of the great offensive tackles around, an excellent player against Charlton. Puts him right on the ground, gives him time to throw the ball. Combination offense. They can do it all when they're on the Auburn Tigers.
Fake. Berger looks in the end zone. Incomplete. Looking for his big tight end, Walter Reeves, who came into the game with 14 catches, 120 yards, but no touchdowns. And Pat Dye says, Kevin, he's the best tight end he's ever coached.
He says he's one of the best in the country. Now, he's open right away. Berger doesn't see him right away. He's to the right of your screen. He'll come into the screen. He was open sooner than that. You see the defense gets in front. And you can't really even tell who that ball was to. It might have been to Mose, Harry Mose, there up in the air.
Second and goal from the 6. Mose tries the left side behind Floyd and Dunn, and there's that man, Clifford Charlton, number 56 again. The big playmaker. Coaches say he's very quiet. 2 years ago, he wasn't even a starter. He started turning heads, though, when he sacked the LSU quarterback, Jack Wickersham, 3 times for a loss of 29 yards and made 3 solo tackles. Since then, it's been tough to get him out of the lineup, eh?
Physical maturity, Jim. These kids grow up overnight. One day they're average, next day they're superstar.
Berger, right corner of the end zone, incomplete and no flag. Lewis Oliver back there on the coverage again, looking for Tillman.
They're double teaming the right guy. Watch number 18 here. Now they want to loft the ball to Tillman again. Mulberry shorter. Now watch Oliver behind him. He makes the catch. That's an interception. His foot was in.
Now that's a timing play. Berger actually releases the ball before, because otherwise, Kevin, I think he would have seen the double coverage and not gone to Tillman.
It was not a good pass. He didn't have time to jump, to get his feet under him and jump.
They'll put it down. It's a 27-yard try. It's up, and it is good by Wynn Lyle.
Now, I don't think this should have been a field goal. I think this should have been Florida's ball. Here's Oliver. Got the ball, and it looked to me like that foot was in as he was controlling the ball.
6:14 to go, and the Auburn Tigers have just taken a 3-0 lead after that 27-yard field goal. The kickoff when we come back. Auburn on top over Florida in this SEC shootout. Happy Halloween from everybody here in Auburn, Louisiana, or in Auburn, Alabama. There'll be some big parties going on tonight.
I didn't know that Kermit and Miss Piggy were still seeing each other.
Well, they had a reconciliation. Chris Johnson out of Fairhope, the sophomore, will kick off number two, and back deep it's Kerry Watkins, number four, who watches it come down and then steps out of bounds at the 5-yard line.
Watkins should have let that ball go. That ball was going out of bounds, would have been a penalty. He didn't know where he was on the field.
All right, let's see now, as you watch Watkins leaving the field, if that last ball... Well, there it is.
That's a kickoff. That's a kickoff. He didn't know where he was on the field, Jim. He's got to know where he is on the field on the kickoff. Probably the most important thing for a kick returner when you get near that goal line or the out-of-bounds line. Big, big error.
96 yards from Pater. Gators in a hole. 6:13 left. Emmett Smith fumbled the last time he had the ball. Well, who had the ball on that intended touchdown toss? It was ruled an incomplete pass, but let's see, Kevin, was it an interception?
Well, possession is the most important thing. The question is his foot down? Yes. Does he have the ball? Yes. Looks to me like he does. It looks to me like that's an interception and that Auburn should not have had the opportunity. This is a zone, actually, at the goal line. He's playing a deep part of the zone. That looks good to me. Tough call, very close, but it looked like an interception.
McGrady, the freshman, is the fullback. He runs right into the heart of the line for Auburn. Robert Goff on the stop. It brings up third and long.
This is where Kerwin Bell, makes a difference for a team. Here's a guy who has started for 4 years. He's beaten Auburn three times. They're backed up, yeah, but here's a guy who can drop back, take a short drop, maybe complete a quick pass.
Anthony Williams now, the senior out of Tampa, Florida, in at fullback.
He's a good receiver, that's why, Jim.
Third and five. Bell to Smith. And Smith up across the 10 near the 11. Quentin Riggins went down low, the sophomore from Montgomery. He's only 6 feet, but 210 pounds. He tackled the load, and Emmett Smith, and it's another punting situation.
Special teams, how important are they? You really put your offense in a hole. This is a pretty high-powered Florida offense with nowhere to go because of the mistake on the kickoff.
Let's see if the Tigers will try and block the punt. McAndrew gets it away, hangs it high, a spiraling kick. Donaldson backs up. He's also a receiver. He's got good hands. Going east-west and is out of bounds at the 41-yard line. A 46-yard kick, and he lost 1 yard on the return. Well, we talked at the very top about freshmen of influence and how they've done. How about through 7 games? Some great names there, too. Griffin, Dorsett, Campbell, Walker, and Bo Jackson. Emmett Smith, 1,011 yards and 11 touchdowns. Better than all of those great names.
I think something to point out here. To one of the most highly recruited players in the nation, and Florida and Auburn came down to the last two schools he was going to go to. He decided on Florida because his friends were at Florida. He felt more comfortable.
Berger already up 3-0. Wants it all. Defender fell down. Complete at the 15. Tillman again. Lewis Oliver slipped at the 30-yard line. A 48-yard reception. They'll spot it at the 12.
Florida defensive backs are having a terrible time keeping their feet. I believe this is Mulberry again. It's the third time Mulberry has slipped. Two completions, and then the almost interception by Oliver. Oliver's got the deep coverage. Mulberry goes down. Tillman runs right by him. They've got to cover this guy. It's not his height that's making the difference. It's the footing. The Florida backs cannot keep their footing.
Mose and Ware in the backfield. The give to Harry Mose, the freshman out of Lake Wales, Florida. And Burnett, the sophomore from Pensacola, stacks him up.
Now, Florida comes into this game knowing Auburn is not a strong running team, but an excellent passing team with Berger. Their defensive secondary has got to be geared to the pass. Maybe they're going to have to play a little softer. It appears that Mulberry, number 32, has got his shirt tied up. If you're trying to pick him out on the field, you can't see his number. And he's having a hard time standing up. He's going to have to change his shoes, or they're going to have to get him out of there.
Second and 10 from the 12. Slap to the right with Wright and Donaldson. Pitch back to Mose. Cracks it over the right side, but Oliver, the junior that time, out of Belgrade, Florida, submarined him down low.
And they moved Oliver up to like a linebacker position. Did a tremendous job. Just played off the block, came right down, forced the running back inside. Tough team to run against, this Florida team. And Auburn, as I said repeatedly, not a great running team. This is difficult for Auburn down here. They really can't power you. Their offensive line not that big and strong.
The ball just outside the 10. It's third and eight. Donaldson wide to the left. Right goes right. Blitz is on. Berger out of the pocket. Will go out of bounds at the 18-yard line. So what might have been a chip shot field goal becomes a little larger. Brown and Charlton chasing Berger out of bounds.
That Florida defense, they give up just over 9 points, and you'll see why. Right through the middle, everybody chasing Berger. Now Berger makes a nice play here again. He doesn't try to dump the ball. He'll take that 3 points, and that's experience again. He's in trouble. He knows he's got a decent field goal kicker, and he goes for the three.
Lyle, one for two between 30 and 39 yards. This from the hash mark near side will be a 36-yard try. Out of the hold of Schulman. It's on its way, and it is good. So the Auburn Tigers, with 2:25 left to go in the first quarter, have taken a 6-0 lead against the Gators of Florida. It's been all Auburn. We'll take a timeout and come back before 85,000, the largest crowd ever, to watch a football game in Alabama. Somewhere. SEC at 7:30 Eastern time with you.
I'm going to go sit in the bus station right after this game and wait for my instructions.
Chris Johnson. Oh, he bangs a beauty. Back deep. Watkins again. This time he stays inbounds at the 4. Dances to the 15 and is hammered down. Gang tackle. Smokey Hodge, the first to arrive. That last scoring drive by the Auburn Tigers. A 36-yard field goal. Lyle has been perfect. First from 22, then from 36.
That excellent defense by Florida on that drive, except for the one pass where Mulberry fell down. Gave Auburn good field position. The Gators held after that. Auburn had to settle for a field goal.
At the 16, the freshman in the backfield, Willie McGrady and Emmett Smith. Bell gives it to Emmett. He just keeps those knees turning up near the 19. Kurt Crane, the first to arrive for the Tigers, the senior out of Birmingham.
Kurt Crane was a guy who was a walk-on, a transfer from Memphis State, number 39. He reads it, comes up, goes right down the line. That's what you're supposed to do. Take a step up and then go down the line if it's wide. This guy's an excellent player. Played for Memphis State early. Came here as a walk-on, earned a scholarship. He's now all-conference.
Dishes it off. Smith, who has 4 carries for 15 yards on the ground, comes up with a reception, but they needed to get up near the 29. Smith on the stop defensively for Auburn, and there is what the freshman has done as far as receiving is concerned. Talk about an all-purpose back.
Well, he's the second leading receiver, Jim, and a real disadvantage for Bell. He's got Simmons, the wideout, is the leading receiver by one catch over Smith, and a lot of passes dropped. He really has few players he can throw it to and count on.
Third and 3. The ball at the 23. Emmett Smith breaks the tackle, dances, keeps on fighting up close to the 25. He'll be about a yard shy. Nate Hill, the senior, out of LaGrange, Georgia, about 45 minutes down the interstate. In fact, LaGrange, Georgia is where the Florida Gators stayed.
He's not going to have gotten this. It was a great job. Going to be fourth down. A great job by the Auburn defense. They read draw, and everybody pursued, got off their blocks. They were able to stop him.
Jamie McAndrew back to punt. His dad, of course, pitched for the Mets and for the Padres. Jamie on a baseball scholarship here at Florida. Duke Donaldson is back deep, averaging about 10 yards per return. It's low. Hits at the 40 and is down at the 38-yard line. A 35-yard punt with 15 seconds left to go. Florida State and Tulane doing battle tonight. And Tim Brando, what's happening?
Well, the Florida State Seminoles are getting it done, Jim Kelly. Let's show you on the reverse. Sammy Smith, but he lets it go to Lewis, and Ronald Lewis will set free. And the Tulane Green Wave, they got out to the 7-0 lead. That sets up the fifth touchdown and the 35th unanswered point. Florida State has since added a field goal. They lead the Green Wave 38-7, and they're rolling.
And both these teams have to play Florida State yet this year.
See, Tulane made them mad. From the 40, Donaldson in motion. Berger airborne again. Middle is wide open. Berger chased out of the pocket. And he's out of bounds at the 42. Jeff Reuter, the junior out of Phoenix, Arizona, chased him out of bounds.
Berger was an option quarterback. We think of him now as a drop-back quarterback, and an excellent one he is, second in the nation in passing efficiency. But this guy was an option quarterback, so when you see him scramble, it's not foreign to him. He knows how to run the ball.
Out of Cedartown, Georgia, came in completing about 70% of his passes. Tillman checks back in at wide receiver number 85. Second and 8 from the 42. Motion by Donaldson. Blitz is on. Berger almost got out of it. Sacked at the 33-yard line. The Gators were coming. The nose guard, Jeff Roth, led the way. And Clifford Charlton was also there, number 56. A loss of 8 as the first quarter has come to an end. Two field goals by the Tigers. They lead the Gators 6-0. Along. I'm Jim Kelly, and welcome back to Jordan-Hare Stadium here in Auburn. Are we seeing a 2-5 defense now? Because Pinner, number 50, and Seeger, 64, are the only down linemen. Everybody else is linebacker.
Well, this definitely is a passing team. You get everybody back.
Berger backpedals. He needs 16. Over the middle, he's got Donaldson at the 40, the 45. Dives to the 48-yard line, where Gerald Dickens pulls him down. Donaldson came in, 18 catches, 185 yards. Most improved wide receiver after the spring practice. Came up about 2 yards shy. So, it's Brian Schulman, the junior punter out of Brentwood, Tennessee, and Jarvis Williams, who averages about 14 yards on the punt returns back deep. High, high, towering kick. Williams, fair catches at the 18. Storyline, Auburn, Alabama. The story, Win Lyle, two field goals. Jeff Berger, who did not start, came in on the second snap. 104 yards passing in the first quarter. Tillman with three big receptions, and Kerwin Bell just 5 yards passing. That's really the story for the Gators.
Well, field position, too, and mistakes by Florida's defense, falling down on pass patterns, and then the problem on the kickoff, putting Florida in poor field position. Field position has been a difficult problem here for the Gators. They have not had any kind of field position to start with. 18-yard line isn't great, and that's where they are right now.
Williams and Smith in the backfield. Play action fake to Emmett Smith. Wide open. Number 25, that's Stacy Simmons. Simmons came in with 16 catches, 257 yards, bumped out by Alvin Briggs.
Simmons, the best of those receivers, almost 300 yards in receptions. He drives off Briggs. And Kerwin Bell right on the mark. There was just no defense on that. Simmons drove him deep, got good speed, and Bell right on the mark on the comeback.
Simmons really came into prominence about a year ago against Auburn when Florida went with three wide receivers and no tight end. From the 39, safety valve to Smith on the screen. There is the explosive speed, and that's what Pat Dye was talking about. He said he's faster than Bo Jackson, his Heisman Trophy winner here at Auburn. He gets to three-step speed in two steps.
Now, there were those that called him a lugger and not a runner. He can lug the ball for me anytime. Bell's experience on the screen. Emmett Smith does things like a senior. They catch Briggs inside, and you don't want to give this guy the sideline. Finally, driven out of bounds there by Crane.
A 15-yard pickup, you can see. Kerwin Bell having problems with the audible. There goes Smith. He's having problems with the Tiger defense. Kurt Crane, number 39, leading tackler a year ago at a Berry High School in Birmingham.
The blitz comes right through the hole and flattens out. Exactly what you have to do. Not Emmett's problem. There's nothing he could have done. Once he made his cut, Crane was right on him. Great experience for him. Not a whole lot of physical talent. Very small out of high school, about 180 pounds. He put on weight, wanted to play big-time football. Came to Auburn, and he's doing just that.
against the grain. A great pass by Bell up near the 42 to Walter Odom, the tight end, the senior out of Miami, Florida. They needed a bunch, and it'll bring up third down. Oklahoma State, no problem with Kansas State, and it's early. Kentucky rolling over Virginia Tech in the second quarter. Good battle going on. Louisville and Tulsa. USC demolishing Washington State at the final. From the 48, third and 12.
Simmons and Smith are the two leading receivers on this team.
Blitz is on. Bell out of the pocket. Needs some help. Incomplete, almost intercepted at the 43-yard line by Edward Phillips. And he got no help, Kevin Kiley, from Simmons, who was open in the vicinity. He should have come back to the quarterback. He just drifted around out there kind of aimlessly.
Take a look at Bell now. Bell has the experience to roll. He knows he's under pressure. He gets outside Rocker in a defense, but this is not a well-thrown ball, as you can see. It's a good thing it wasn't. It would have been intercepted.
McAndrew on a baseball scholarship to Donaldson. Will kick it away. Hits inside the 15 and will be killed inside the 5. Great special teams play by the Gators. A 44-yard punt. Tigers lead 6-0, but they'll start from their own 4. And Johnson, Hotel and Lodges. Wish they had one of those here in Auburn. There is our time left in the first half. Galen Hall must be concerned. His offense ineffective, and he's got two superstars in freshman Emmett Smith and quarterback Kerwin Bell. Jeff Berger bends in at quarterback, but from his own pool. Looked like the nose guard, Jeff Roth, jumped off sides along with Rondy Weston. Now, were they drawn off sides?
Cadence, there's your experience again. Here's that Berger experience. When they all jump, you know it's Cadence. And Reggie Slack on the sideline probably knows now why he came out after one play. Berger has shown in kind of an odd way, really. It's not that he's moving the team up and down the field, but the little things he's done, the experience factor, throwing the ball away, changing the cadence, giving his team some playing room down here near the goal line. He's really doing it right.
First penalty tonight. So instead of first and 10 from the 4, first and 5 from the 9. Quick snap. Big hole right side by Garner and Searles. Reggie Ware, the senior out of Huntsville, and Henry Brown on the stop. Quick hitter on that right side, and Hudson, the center, also helped open up that hole.
Well, they give it to Reggie. He's a good short yardage runner. Only averages 2.9 coming in per carry, but he's a guy that doesn't fumble. Now, they do two smart things there. They get first and 5, then they give it to their short yardage guy. That 5 yards meant a lot.
Complete at the 23-yard line. Berger, now 8 of 13, finds Walter Reeves, the tight end.
Clifford Charlton, 6'3", 240-pound outside linebacker, following the blocker inside, coming all the way around, and letting Berger know he's there. That type of thing is cumulative over the time of a game, over the length of a game. A quarterback can surely feel that over 4 quarters.
Berger, 8 of 13, 111 yards. Second and 5. Motion by Alexander Wright. Forward motion, but not much by Reggie Ware. Bang backwards. The center of that Gator defense. This is an aggressive, hard-hitting football game.
I'm going to tell you what, Reggie Ware is 6'2", 236 pounds. And he was stopped dead in his tracks by, I guess it was that guy Gatlin, number 48. Got his helmet, I couldn't see from here, but whoever it was got the helmet right under the chin. And just put a stop to him. Looks like Gatlin shaken up by his own tackle. That'll happen.
He's not a member of the Gatlin brothers.
He's probably seeing double or triple. How many Gatlin brothers are there?
They all sing.
They're probably all singing in his head.
Line of scrimmage, the 22-yard line, as Donaldson and Wright come out wide to the right.
They've been going to the tight end on little hook patterns in this situation.
Berger needs 5. Got Donaldson. Donaldson, first down, and he's off to the races. Trips up over his own feet at the 40-yard line. out of Cairo High School in Cairo, Georgia. His high school nickname, the Syrup Makers.
They said they would follow Charlton around here, number 56, try to use tackles to pick him up. The middle of the line does a nice job on Charlton, giving Berger chance to drop it right in there to Donaldson. Now Donaldson, he trips himself up, gets a little tricky with the feet, and down he goes. But first down, Auburn.
He was a quarterback in high school, passed for 2,300 yards and 25 touchdowns. There goes Terry Mose, the freshman, and look out, he turns the corner across the 45-yard line on a good carry, and Louis Oliver tripped him up.
Well, Harry Mose ran for 2,800 yards in high school, and the reason he's in there, he's got some speed, and speed is what they were lacking in the Auburn backfield. They've had some great runners over the years. Of course, Bo and Brent Fullwood and William Andrews and James Brooks. They needed to get some speed in there. They had some problems fumbling the ball, the young guys early in the year, but Pat Dye went back to him. Last week, that man, Harry Mose, ran for 106 yards. First time all year an Auburn back had broken 100 yards rushing.
Out of Lake Wales High School, where he played his ball for James Hale. Second and five. Nothing doing for Stacy Danlin. Rondi Weston on the stop, and again, Weston is playing with that broken jaw and that helmet that looks more like a lampshade.
Broken in two places, and a week ago, they said it was possible he would not, number 68, leaving the game right there, said he might not play for the remainder of the year. It was broken in an altercation in a tavern. And as of right now, it has not been resolved. Nobody knows what happened at this point, except that he has a broken jaw, but he's out here playing with it.
Third and four. Donaldson's been Berger's main man. Again, the ex-quarterback drops the ball at the 49-yard line. Watkins and Dixon on the coverage.
Excuse me, Jim, a bad pass thrown inside. Berger had hit his last four up until that pass. Now Florida going into this game believes that they can block a punt against Auburn, and they feel that they can come up the middle and get some penetration on these guys at one point in the game.
Three punts, 39-yard average so far tonight. Fair catch is signaled for by Jarvis Williams, and then he runs with the ball. And now the penalty flag is down. That's just a mental error. You signal for the fair catch.
Special teams play has been a problem. You see Shulman making that gesture with his arm. Florida killing themselves just receiving kicks. That should not happen. A player with that kind of experience.
He's already caught one punt that should have gone out of bounds at the four.
The lay of game on the receiving team will set the chains. It'll be first and 15.
That's Dick Burleson, and that is Galen Hall. We'll take a timeout. 9:42 left in the first half. It's been all Auburn. What Jarvis Williams? Now, he already muffed one punt. I said that he took the kickoff at the four. That was Kerry Watkins. But he's muffed one punt, and there he signals for the fair catch. And delay of game penalty was called as he tried to advance the football. A rather solemn Florida Gator unit. How about Emmett Smith? Five carries, just 17 yards. So the Tigers have done a great job of stuffing Smith.
Florida trailed 17-0 in the fourth quarter of this game last year. And Kerwin Bell came in, led him to an 18-17 victory. This is a team that knows they can come back against Auburn. 6-0 will not get this team down.
Line of scrimmage, the 6-yard line. Bell gives it to Smith. Cracks it for four tough yards. Big battle in the SEC, LSU and Ole Miss. And how are the Rebels and the Tigers doing, Timmy?
All right, Jim, thank you very much. Right now, Mark Young, one touchdown pass for Ole Miss. But the story, the Hotson to Wendell Davis. Boy, have we heard that combination before. Two touchdown strikes, one of 45, another of 11 yards. LSU, which leads Auburn by just a half game in the SEC standings, a 14-10 halftime lead. Back to Jim.
So Mike Archer's got his Tigers on track. They've got a four-point lead at the intermission. Right here, Bell's trying to get the Gators on track, and it is incomplete and almost picked off. Kevin Porter had it at the 40-yard line, was diving. That would have been a tough one, but Bell misfired. Third and 10 coming up.
Darrell Woolard is the receiver. Kevin Porter way out. This ball way overthrown. Porter the only one with a chance at it. and that's why he's a defensive back and not a wide receiver.
Here we go, Gabe. Here we go. Here we go.
The line of scrimmage, the 11-yard line. Bell now, 3 of 7, 42 yards. Smith will fall 4 yards shy of the necessary yardage. Edwin Phillips on the stop. Listen to 85,000 Tiger fans at Auburn, Alabama.
They're not only cheering because Auburn is winning, they're cheering because Emmitt Smith is not getting a lot of yardage. But I'll tell you what, there are not many backs in America that would have over 20 yards in this game, and Smith does. That was a pretty good run.
Smith needed 23 yards to become the second all-time leading ground gainer for Florida, passing Neil Anderson. Here is Duke Donaldson on the receiving end. Will advance it to the 46-yard line of the Gators. Auburn leads 6-0. 8:17 left to go before halftime. A 32-yard punt, a 2-yard return.
In an effort to...
Kevin Kiley is along. Back. You see the time left before halftime. 8:17 to go. Even though it's 6-0 and it has been all Auburn, Florida's just one play from getting back into this football game and taking the lead.
Their defense has done an outstanding job, but their field position has been terrible. They've turned the ball over, stepped out of bounds. A lot of mistakes, and yet Auburn has only been able to generate those two field goals. Jim, you're right. They're very close in this game.
Danley, the only running back. Motion by Donaldson. Danley's got it. They've got the reverse to right. Berger throws a block. And Charlton stayed at home. That's what I said earlier. He takes away half of the field. Good example right there.
Experience, a key. When you have a guy who's played a lot of downs, 56, left corner of your screen, he starts to come. And look at him break out and flatten out. Play off of Berger. And on a reverse, there should not be that many orange helmets around the ball, but there was. And that's good experience and great coaching and an outstanding player, Clifford Charlton, right in the middle of it.
Holding call against the Tigers, only the second penalty of the football game.
Another thing, you should never hold on a reverse play, on a deception play. What's the reason you hold? You hold because the play breaks down. If it works, everybody should be going in the wrong direction anyway. There's no reason to hold it.
ESPN, your source for pregame analysis and postgame reflection on the National Football League. At 11:30 Eastern Time, join Chris Berman, Pete Axelm, Tom Jackson on NFL Game Day. A one-hour preview of all the day's games. And you can bet tomorrow they'll be talking about that big three-way trade between the Rams, the Colts, and the Bills. Eric Dickerson reunited with his old coach from SMU, Ron Meyer, Indianapolis. Next Sunday, 8 o'clock Eastern Time, the defending Super Bowl champion Giants and the Patriots. They take the penalty from the 43 now of Auburn. It's first and 20. Ware and Danley are in the backfield. And there goes the freshman, Stacy Danley. Second and 14 coming up now as Webby Burnett, the sophomore out of Pensacola, made the stop. Reggie Ware, number 36, the senior. He's the fullback out of Huntsville, Alabama. Danley, the tailback. Tillman and Donaldson are the wide receivers. And Berger, the senior quarterback out of Cedartown, Georgia. Out of the eye, pro set. Berger backpedals, gets it to Danley. Dances down to the 46. He'll be about 10 yards shy. Charlton again.
If you saw our earlier broadcast, Florida LSU, you know that when Jeff Roth, the middle guard, went out of the game with an ankle injury, the Florida defense just wasn't the same. He's a great player, nose guard. Number 96. Now, this is a screen. They're going to let him come. But he's the type of guy that you really need to contain in that Florida defense. You have to double team him and stop him. He's the type of guy that opens it up for the rest of the defense. A great player. He's operating on a bad ankle, but as you can see, pretty mobile.
Berger, 10 of 16, 132 yards. Needs 11 long ones here. Blitz is on. Penalty flag is down at the snap, and so is Donaldson at the 49. That flag, Kevin, was thrown all the way back at the 30-yard line of the Gators.
Well, that was a great job. I don't know if they were holding or not, but what a job by the Auburn offensive line picking up that blitz down the middle. Nobody got through. I don't know what the call is here. Let's see if we can.
Dick Burleson is the referee.
Well,
ineligible receiver downfield, but he pointed toward Florida.
I noticed that.
Illegal substitution. Illegal substitution against the Gators. Apparently they had 12 men on the field, and that's why the back judge threw the flag down so quickly. Looked over that secondary. He said, you can have a nickel back, but you can't have two of them.
Yeah, even a better job picking up the blitz with an extra guy on there. That's going to be a first down, Auburn. Another mistake.
That's a huge mistake, because it would have been a punting situation. Two penalties against Florida, one against Auburn. Line of scrimmage all the way down at the 33-yard line. Donaldson comes wide to the left. Ware and Danley in the I pro set. The audible by the quarterback, Jeff Berger. Danley. Right side blocking by Garner and Searles. Charlton again. You know, coaches say for Auburn that 75% of the time, opponents run or pass away from that man. They're going right at him.
Well, it's good. Well, a lot of times if you play the tight end, he's on the weak side here, and there's nobody blocking him. Nobody blocking him at all. He kind of sits on the corner there and comes back down in. But a way to neutralize him is to play a tight end over him, make him play that tight end. He has to hit the tight end before he releases it, occupies him, slows him down a little bit.
Second and eight. Berger looks all kinds of time. Incomplete at the 18-yard line, looking for Tillman. Oliver back on the coverage. Those two will go to the locker room together. They've been inseparable.
They talk about Jarvis Williams, Jim, on this team. Oliver a step behind him. Of course, Williams, a candidate for the Thorpe Award. Watch Oliver. Watch the acceleration here. Almost intercepts that ball. And that's what a safety is supposed to do. Lewis Oliver, he's a great one.
They say he's got size, speed, strength, savvy, and smarts. 6'2", 214. 4.3 speed. He bench presses 355, and he's a National Honor Society member with a 3.5 grade average. Third and eight. Safety valves it out to Reggie Ware. Beats a tackle inside the 25, and a flag is down. Odom, the freshman from Merritt Island, Florida, and Charlton helped out. First down, Auburn.
Boy, they've almost got him here on the corner. I can't pick up who it is, but watch this play by a Florida player. He just gets no help. That's Charlton. No help at all, and Ware able to get outside. If there was anybody over there on that play besides him, they would have had it stopped, and he almost made the play by himself.
Reggie Ware right there. Fumbled against Florida last year, Kevin. He's not known as a pass receiver. They worked on it all spring, and you know how they did?
How?
With a frisbee.
Did he catch the frisbee? I guess he did.
He was most improved frisbee catcher in the spring. From the 22, they picked up the penalty flag. No call was made, and inside the 16-yard line goes Rock Harris, number 21. Meanwhile, Mississippi State and 17th-ranked Alabama zip to zip. Kentucky by two touchdowns against Virginia Tech. Memphis State leading Arkansas State by a touchdown. And Louisville still leading Tulsa there at the half.
Barn burner there.
It is for Howard Snellenberg. Second down and four. Berger. Slowly up to the line. And now a flag is down, and it might be delay of game.
Now it's going to be offside. It's going to be on Walter Reeves, the tight end. That was supposed to go on just first sound, and I don't know what Reeves did.
Illegal procedure on the offense.
That was going to be a quick snap, but not quite that quick, Walter.
Tillman checks in, carrying a play from head coach Pat Dye, and checking out Scott Bolton, senior from Theodore, Alabama. So up to the line they go, the line of scrimmage, the 21. It's second down and nine. Danley and Ware in the backfield. Is open. Berger goes the other way, and he's got Danley at the 15. Dickens has Danley. Incomplete, they're saying now. He did not catch the ball. Danley, a redshirt freshman out of Douglas County High School in Douglasville, Georgia. Did he catch it?
Not enough to go down low. You've got to keep your arms on the ground to protect the ball. Too tough there. Looked to me like he had it. Might have gotten through his elbow towards the back there. Good call by the official if that was the case. Tough to see. Big down here now for Auburn.
Big down for Florida.
Yes.
Berger, 5 out of 8 this quarter, 49 yards. Diving down to the 20 and trying to crawl for a little more. Goes Danley again in the grasp of the nose guard, Jeff Roth.
Now, if I was on the Auburn defense and they ran that play, I'd be puffing my chest out because what he just did there was he ran that play. Pat Dye ran that play. He's telling his defense, the Auburn defense, that he has confidence in him. If he gets 3 more, Florida needs 2 scores to get ahead. And he's telling them, don't let him get 2 scores. Running play, 3rd and long.
37-yard field goal try for the sophomore from Auburn, Wynn Lyle. He's hit 2 already on its way. And it's now a 9-0 Auburn lead. The Tigers, with 3:09 left to go, have made it more than a touchdown. The Gators need 9 to tie. Touchdown and the field. Kind of an awesome task against this Auburn defense playing at home on Halloween night when your offense is sputtered completely.
Yeah, but they have had success in past years late in the game, and this was expected to be a squeaker. I don't think anybody thinks they're out of the game for Florida.
Watkins is back deep. Goes to the far sideline at the 7. That was a very strange kickoff return. Watkins was looking for any kind of blocking and didn't get it. He was out there. All he saw was blue jerseys. A 9-yard return. The 3rd field goal from 37 yards out by Wynn Lyle. Now the most field goals against Florida, 6 by Kentucky back in 1982. So Auburn already halfway to a new record.
Well, Lyle is 10 for 13 on the year. He's only missed 3, missed all 3 of those field goals against Georgia Tech in a game where Auburn had to come back late and win. He's only missed 3, and they were all in one game. He's pretty good.
Emmett Smith, the super freshman, the tailback. Kerwin Ballard, quarterback, goes airborne over the middle, loops it out, gets it to Walter Odom, the tight end. And the 6'4", 233-pound senior out of Miami, upended by Kurt Crane.
Part of the problem with an offense is you look at the Florida offense, the Auburn's field position on their own 28 does not include, you have to remember some of the turnovers and mistakes in the defense. Florida's killed themselves with field position making mistakes. They've not been able to open up their offense.
No huddle, blitzes on. Bell backpedals, sidewinds it out. Out of the backfield, Emmett Smith dives to get out of bounds and tries to stop the clock. Phillips hanging on.
If I'm Auburn, I'm going to cover Smith and I'm going to cover Simmons. Make sure I've got my best people covering those guys, that they're aware of those two people, and make the rest of the Florida offense catch the ball. It's been a weakness all year.
Again, no huddle. Gators going quickly. Blitz again. Bell chased out. Incomplete, trying to get it to 36. Anthony Williams, pressure by Andre Bruce, the senior out of Montgomery. We talked about number 93 at the very top. 6'6", 236, and here he comes.
Yeah, he's been quiet most of the game. Look at this. Look at this job he does on Bell. He not only pressures him, but he stays on his feet even after Bell changes direction, and he's able to get his body on the body of the quarterback, which is the main idea. Great player, and talking about Georgia Tech, he had a big one there. 3 interceptions against Georgia Tech. Almost won the game single-handedly.
Bell, 5 of 10. He needs one. They won't get it. Andre Bruce again trips up Emmett Smith. They call number 93 Black Thunder.
Yeah, and I'll bet you they'll be calling him that down in Gainesville. He was a basketball player. They recruited him because they saw him as a basketball player. Had great physical ability. Although Smith fell forward and got the first down on that play, Bruce was all over him. And Florida now getting in out of the huddle a lot quicker, not allowing Auburn to set their defense.
From the 38, they said Smith got the first down. Bell, far sideline man, open first down. That's Mills. Mills, number 14, dropped the first pass of the game, which would have been a scoring strike. He was wide open. This time he hung on, and Briggs bumps him out of bounds.
Yeah, what a pass by Bell, Jim, there. He was looking over the whole field. He picked up Mills, and he was able to get the ball to him. It's kind of a strange throwing motion. Seems like he throws leaning back, but what an arm.
The Gator with not much bite so far tonight.
Well, get me one of those before I go home. That was something I'd like to have.
Yeah, you can put it in your cap. almost a great catch by Mills. Kind of the volleyball tip at the 23. Could have been caught. Equally could have been intercepted up there. Free ball. Staples back, the first blue jersey to arrive.
This is one of those patterns for a wide receiver coming over the middle. 5'11", 172-pound freshman. Now, this ball is well thrown. Bella Gett hits him in his shoulder pad. Well, that's the worst thing that can happen to a wide receiver, have it go up in the air and have to concentrate on it to get broken right in half.
They fake the play action to Smith. Wide open, complete at the 30-yard line. Inside the 20 goes Clifton Reynolds, number 81. Reynolds, the junior, redshirted in 84. Four catches coming in. That's a big one.
Bell does a great thing on this play. The experience and the poise of Bell is just unbelievable. He gains enough time himself and then just finds this guy wide open for big yardage.
From the 19, little slant-in pattern inside the 15. And they come right back to Clifton Reynolds. Why not? The good hands.
If I was Kerwin and I had a guy catch the ball, I'd get it to him as often as possible, the way things have gone.
1:39 left to go. It's 9-0 Auburn, but the Florida Gators igniting here late. They're knocking on the door. The Gators here now, the line of scrimmage, the 13-yard line. It's 2nd and 4. You look at that Florida huddle, and Kerwin Bell has really come alive. He was 8-for-14 of the game, 7-for-11 this quarter. In the backfield, Williams and Smith. Good time for a draw. There it is. Inside the 10 goes the super freshman out of Pensacola, Crane, and the stop.
As Jim said, a good time for a draw. If you're playing defense, you've got to feel this thing. You can't see it. They drop back. They make it look like a pass, and then they just turn you. And here comes the leading rusher in the nation, Emmitt Smith, looking for 4 yards for a first down, and he gets it.
And he had a busy off week. He was on everybody's television show. The only one he missed was David Letterman. That's because he had the twins. Bell, incomplete. That was just... Let's not get sacked. He just dumped that one off in the direction of Clifton Reynolds.
I'd like to be a Florida offensive lineman, turn around before the snap and see Kerwin Bell and Emmitt Smith standing there. That'd make me feel pretty good.
Well, I wouldn't want to be Florida and see Andre Bruce standing there.
Yeah, that's right. Before the snap, I would.
I didn't even want to see Bruce at practice the other day. You know, they say that Andre Bruce has got a little bit of a screw loose. He's a little bit of a prankster. He's been known to chase his teammates around in the dorm with a machete.
Yeah, well.
You want him on your side.
Without the machete.
Blitz is on. Bell backpedals, in trouble, gets out of it. And now he's down at the 13-yard line. A great play by the nose guard, Benji Rowland. And Andre Bruce made it all possible.
Just his size, 6'6", 236, and all that athletic ability. Look at him pressure. Now, Bell has no concentration. His receivers are not helping him. They're young. They're inexperienced. They're not coming back. Willard gets loose on the inside, but holding up your hands is not enough, Darrell. You got to get back into his vision so he can find you and throw the ball to you. Lack of experience. The receiver, excellent athletes, good receivers, but lack of experience. They don't concentrate, they drop the ball, and they make mistakes like that.
Yeah, you could wave the goalpost back and forth, and if you've got Andre Bruce, 6'6", 236, chasing you, and they've got his lumberjack arms up in the face, you're not going to see anybody wave.
You've got to get in the field of vision. That's the key. Waving your arms, you can't wait for him to turn his head around. If he does, somebody's liable to grab it, a defensive player. Get over there where he can see, and he can throw the ball to you.
At halftime, Tim Brando will have a lot of scores and highlights. Beano Cook will also be on hand. Ohio State upset by Michigan State. A lot of upsets again.
No upset there.
I told you Bobby McAllister would bring the Spartans back.
They're gone to the option. Michigan State's a good team, and they're maturing as they go through the year. Carlos doing a good job up there.
Halftime with Tim and company coming up in 71 seconds. 3rd and 13. Gators have one timeout left. Incomplete to Smith at the 15, but I'm here to tell you, Kevin, number 14, wide open in the end zone, Ernie Mills. You can't get any more wide open than Mills was.
Same problem for Bell. He's being chased around. He's concentrating more on the rush. Nobody's fault, concentrating more on the rush. Here they come again. Now Bell's moving his feet, chasing around. He just can't pick up receivers. You're right, Mills was wide open. There's no way to see him.
Robert McGinney used to kick for the Auburn Tigers. This one is up, and it is good. So the Gators get on the board with 59 seconds left to go. Well, we talked about McGinney last year, Kevin. He hit a 57-yarder against Auburn in the fourth quarter that started to bring the Gators back. They eventually went on to win that game 18-17. But he kicked for Pat Dye here at Auburn. And then what happened?
Well, he missed a big field goal against Alabama. And he decided, they all decided, the coaching staff and everybody decided that he was a little bit inconsistent, and McGinney was not on scholarship, wanted to be on scholarship. And they decided that they would not give him a scholarship, and he wanted to go to Florida, where he walked on, and he's become an excellent kicker. However, he is not on scholarship at Florida either. Came back here last year, of course, or against Auburn last year, and kicked that big field goal. But they say it's an excellent field goal with a big leg, and you can see it right there. He drilled it.
So we have a six-point Florida deficit with 59 seconds left to go.
It's a big field goal. They down, and we talked about the fact they needed two scores to get ahead in this game. Now again, they need only one. Good drive by Florida. A lot of things happened in that drive. You'll see again in the second half.
And again, the Gators are just one play out from taking the lead. Perry Mose, 25, is back deep. This is a beautiful kick by McGinney at the goal line. Mose will bring it out and is tripped up at the 12. 55 seconds left to go, an 11-yard return, but the Gators, Kevin, with just one timeout. So if you're thinking, even if the defense would stiffen, it's unlikely they'll get the ball back. McGinty, the ex-Tiger, for the Gators from 30 yards out. The only score Florida's put on the board, but it was a big one. Two tight ends are in now. Walter Reeves, 86. Lee March Sellers, 84. Reggie Ware. Pat Dye is content to sit on a 9-3 lead. 45 seconds to go right now, coming up before halftime. Well, we know next week, Kevin, that Bob Rathman and Lee Corso will be in Chapel Hill for that Clemson, North Carolina game. You and I will either be right back here in Auburn for Auburn against Florida State, or we could be down in Baton Rouge for Alabama against LSU. 23 seconds left to go. Out of the eye pro set, they'll keep it on the ground conservatively to Reggie Ware, and that should be the last snap of the first half. So three field goals for the Auburn Tigers and one field goal for the Florida Gators. That's been all the scoring in the 64th renewal of a great SEC rivalry. The concern all over Galen Hall's face, and 85,000 Tiger fans are happy. We'll be happy, Tim Brando, if you can tell us where we're going next week. Where will we be? Back here in Auburn or Baton Rouge?
All right, Jim. Well, I tell you, either place, you're going to have a pretty good game, and of course, you'll have the welcome wagon.
So I'm a great battle guy. The SEC. Hi again, everybody. I'm Jim Kelly. Kevin Kiley is alongside. And partner, we are seeing the emergence of two very dominating linebackers, one on each side of the ball. First, for Auburn, they've had the ball 20 minutes, but because of number 56, Clifford Charlton, they've only been able to punch it in for three field goals. On the other side, Andre Bruce, Florida only has 30 yards rushing. As you know, they average 261 yards per game.
Well, they can make life miserable for you. It's the Lawrence Taylor syndrome. Here's a sight no offensive lineman ever wants to see, 56 Clifford Charlton. Now watch him follow the blocker and come in and knock Berger right on his behind there after he throws the ball, though. Now Clifford not happy with that. Here he is from the outside. Watch him handle Jim Thompson. Great strength, great athletic ability, great linebacker play. Now that's something that Lawrence Taylor made famous. Clifford Charlton's helping. Now here's another guy, Andre Bruce, out of a three-point stance. This is what they can do today. This guy's 6'6", about 240 pounds. Taking on the blocker, watch him change direction. This is something 10, 15 years ago, you'd have had trouble getting that out of a linebacker. This is a guy that has great strength, great athletic ability, and he's tough. Pulling down. There's a lot of pro dollars right there. Emmett Smith and Andre Bruce, two of the great players in college football today. Great linebacking play, Jim.
All right, Kevin, we're watching Chris Johnson, the sophomore out of Fairhope. Kerry Watkins is back deep. Florida, of course, won the toss to start the game, but they wanted the ball to start the second half. Turned out to be a good guess. It is deep. It is end over end, and it's number four, Kerry Watkins, across the 15. Loose football. Auburn's got it. Fairfax caused the fumble, and Steve Brown out of Bellevue picked it up. Here's Watkins. There's Billingsley stripping him of the football, and Auburn comes up with their second key turnover of the night. Great field position outside the 20-yard line.
Special teams been a disaster, Jim, for Florida. Watkins, two big errors. Been a difficult night.
A fumble, and he fielded a kickoff at the four and then stepped out of bounds. Berger wants six, and it is incomplete. A wrestling match at the goal line between Ricky Mulberry, number 32, and Lawyer Tillman, number 85. Tillman, 6'4", Mulberry, 5'10". He's got springs in those feet.
Well, you can see Berger going for that advantage. Tillman can jump, so can Mulberry. A little bit of double coverage, the short man. Mulberry gets back on the zone there, did not lose his footing on this play, and you can see the result of double coverage. They got a sandwich on Tillman. Good defense by that Florida secondary, under pressure again with the turnover.
Mulberry had knee surgery in the spring. He's got 4-4 speed. Berger goes back, trying to set up the screen, will throw it out of bounds. The experience of Jeff Berger, the senior quarterback, looking in the general direction of Danley. It's third and 10 coming up. Weston and Roth with pressure, and again Rondy Weston, number 68, the junior out of Belgrade, Florida, playing with that helmet specially constructed because he's got a broken jaw.
Well, he gets my most courageous of the game, certainly, and probably of the year, the decade, and the century. Broken in two places, and he's out there. And how about Berger here? He's had a rough week, but he's in there throwing.
Auburn 7-for-12 on third down conversion. The post, touchdown to Tillman. There he is. He led the SEC in yards per catch last year, just under 21 yards. He had four touchdown catches coming in, chalked up number five.
And he and Berger did it against a great defense. Florida secondary had only given up two touchdown passes in the last 55 quarters. That's over 14 games. This is a great play. Now Berger takes a short drop, and they use that 6'4 advantage. Williams is only 6 foot, and that's the difference. Now Williams thinks that he can knock the ball loose. He's a great hitter. He's known as being a pounder. Short drop, and he knows where he's going right away, right on the mark, exactly where it needs to be. Williams tried to go through Tillman. He didn't. Tillman tough, holding on to the ball.
And he knows how to go for that ball. He was a free safety in high school, played for Bill Jesse at LaFleur High School. He also averaged 40 yards as a punter. So Tillman, who's a classical music buff, puts the first touchdown on the board tonight. Until now, it's been a battle of field goals. And how important was that turnover to start the second half? It would have been Florida's ball instead. Three plays later, Auburn's on top by 12.
Two kickoff mistakes, Jim, resulted directly in 10 points. And what do they say about Galen Hall? They say he's very patient, kind of a plodder out there.
He'll have to be, because Auburn takes the timeout to set up the two-point conversion try. Berger, after conferring with Pat Dye, motion by Donaldson, sprints to the right, looks to the right, fires, caught, and it is no good on the two-point try. Donaldson stopped about a half yard shy. 14-37 left to go in the third quarter. Auburn on top of Florida by 12.
Once you look through a Minolta.
ESPN's presentation of CFA football being brought to you by the Heartbeat of America. Today, Chevrolet. And by Tempstar, the newest name in home heating and air conditioning. You can rely on the star. Chris Johnson will kick off again. The last time, Kerry Watkins fumbled. Watkins, who also fielded the ball at the four and then stepped out of bounds, will not take this kickoff. Stacy Simmons, there he is, number 25, who's also a wide receiver, the sophomore out of Clearwater, is back deep now. Galen Hall's patient, but he's not foolish. That's exactly where Watkins took it out of bounds. Simmons stays in and explodes. Penalty flag is down. This one's coming back. At the 30, dancing feet up near the 33-yard line for Simmons. Steve Brown, number 38 on the stop. There he is, going out of the screen. But a flag to be checked out. The referee, Dick Burleson. The flag thrown at about the 18-yard line. And the Gators digging a rather large hole. There's Galen Hall. Kerwin Bell, the quarterback. Not been his fault. Miscue, fumble, led to 3 points on the field goal by Lyle in the first half. And Kevin, that last fumble by Watkins set up a three-play scoring drive for six.
Well, the kickoffs have been a disaster. The punts, not much better. Bell has been faced with poor field position, but he's the type of guy in the huddle, I'm sure, after 4 years of starting and the success he's had against Auburn, he's the guy you want back there.
Well, there was a time that Florida felt they could not win in this series. We talked about this being the 64th renewal. These two teams battled to a 7-all tie back in 1939, and then the Gators didn't win again until 1973. Of course, Auburn's not won in Gainesville since 72, so there are jinxes and superstitions on Halloween night on both sides.
I don't know if I could get my shoes on right in this stadium. 85,000.
Emmett Smith. There is the explosiveness around the right side. Crane finally wrestled him down, blocking on that right side by Starwiski and Davis. But Smith, 11 carries, 34 yards, just rambled for 12 more. So he's got 46 now. And he had, what, six games of 100 yards or more coming in?
33 straight counting high school. 28 of those were in high school. Five games coming in. He didn't start the first two games of the year.
They'll go the other way and explodes that way going across the 30, blocking by Williams, Sims, and Daniels. And Staples stops him there. How'd you like to be a paltry six-footer and see Emmett Smith, 210 pounds coming at you with nobody in between?
Andre Bruce getting picked off there by Williams at the corner. A nice job. And Smith coming outside. Now, he's a guy that they say runs better inside the tackles. They're trying him wide now to see if they can break him.
McGrady, the fullback. Smith. And Bell unloads wide open. His Mills gets free, still free. Got to go forward.
Well, these guys are young. You know, you really see it on almost every reception, Jim. They're young, they're dancers. There's still a little bit of high school in him. Mills, a great receiver, great athletic ability, but you're right. He dances around as could possibly lose yardage on that. As he gets later in college and into the pros, if he goes, he'll learn to catch the ball and drive forward. Get that forward yardage. Pick up that extra 3 yards.
Woolard, 21. Sneed, 9 are the wideouts on first and 10 from the 39. Slotted left. Gang tackled at the 40-yard line goes Smith. And the first blue jersey to arrive from LaGrange, Georgia, Nate Hill, number 99.
Toughest test of the year for Smith and the offensive line of Florida. Number 74, Rocker. He's a tough cookie. Off the block, closes immediately. Exactly what you have to do. Auburn's done a great job inside on Smith, which is Smith's strength. But they've had a little success early here running wide. Maybe they'll go back to it.
14 carries, 57 yards for number 22, Emmett Smith. Second and 8. Bell can run. Chopped down near the 43. Andre Bruce, number 93, got there.
It's a great block up the middle by somebody in that offensive line. Just blasted Kurt Crane and put him over on his back. Now, I don't know if it was David Smith, Dave Williams, but Dave Williams, they call it a roach. Florida's offensive line calls it a roach when they knock the defender on their back. And somebody did that to Crane on that play.
Five defensive backs in now. John Wiley, the freshman, checks in number nine as the nickel. It's third and four. Penalty flag is down. And Bell gives a little stiff arm to Andre Bruce. Yeah. And Andre says, no, wait a minute. Yeah. The whistle had blown. Flag was down. I don't think you want to get Andre mad.
Well, that was not a good idea.
Was he some kind of player in high school?
Dead ball foul. False start. Off end.
So it'll be third and nine. Andre Bruce was a defensive end, a tight end, and a wide receiver. He wasn't a boxer, though. Says Kerwin. Wait a minute.
Yeah. Andre said, well, I'll see you later, Kerwin.
Yeah.
I'll see you later from behind.
We've got 27 minutes to go. I think Andre will get the equalizer before this one is through. Wide to the left, Darrell Woolard. Top of your screen, Willie Snead. It is Snead at midfield.
It's going to be a first down, and if there are pro scouts here, and I'm sure there are, they've got to be drooling over that play. What a pass.
Snead, a walk-on out of the University of Virginia with 4-5 speed. Well, there are scouts here from the All-American Bowl, from the Fiesta Bowl, from the Citrus Bowl, the Gator Bowl, the Hall of Fame Bowl, the Orange, Peach, and Sugar Bowl. You know, and talking with, while we have the injury timeout, Pat Dye yesterday at practice about 5 o'clock. Well, we'll pick up on that story in just a second. We've got 11:58 to go. Auburn leads Florida by 12. Let's take timeout. 58 in a wide open quarter. Florida took the opening kickoff and fumbled. Auburn punched it in for the only touchdown of the night and missed on the two-point conversion. But the Gators have got something going now. Woolard wide left as you look at Kerwin Bell. Top of the screen, Willie Snead from midfield. Smith explodes for 5 tough yards. Blocking by the junior center out of Chipley, Florida, Tracy Daniels. All right, Pat Dye at practice last night. We were talking about the Big 8 and Oklahoma and Nebraska both winning big today. Looking at bowl situations, and Pat Dye made no bones about it. He said, I'd much rather have to play Oklahoma than Nebraska. And the way he's stuffing the ground game of Florida tonight, I guess you could see why.
Got that great front, those three down guys, and the excellent linebackers, Bruce and Crane, and I think that's where he's coming from on that.
The 30-yard line by Snead again. First down again. Tripped up at the 25 by Greg Staples. Andre Bruce putting pressure on Bell. Rolling left, but throwing back against the grain.
Well, you can give this completely to Bell. Watch the move he makes here. How he's going to go up and out against. See, Bruce, 93. Now he goes up and out. Time for the crossing pattern. Nobody's going to cover anybody that long. Just a great, great pass and job. Bell. And here's Bruce, how quick he is, trying to go around the outside, but Bell is his equal, coming up inside.
Smith kind of slithered forward for the last 2 yards, ran out of the grasp of number 98, and while we check it out, 99, Nate Hill, let's go back to the studios. What's going on with LSU, Timmy?
All right, Jim, let's see. I've got the travel agency's ticket right here. Where are you going to go next week? You and Kevin, I know you want to know. LSU Ole Miss, 76-yard touchdown run for Harvey Williams after an Eddie Fuller 10-yard touchdown run. The Tigers are rolling against Ole Miss 35-13.
It's great that they're rolling. It doesn't tell us where we're rolling to. Smith. He got to the 20 all by himself. You talk about two tough yards upended by Kevin Porter. We'll either be back here at Auburn for a great game, Or we'll be at another site for another great game.
Yeah.
Alabama and LSU. We can't lose. The only thing is, do we have dinner at Phil's Oyster Bar with our pal Gus on Thursday night down in Baton Rouge? Or do we go back to the Hungry Hunter here in town?
I'll cook for you.
It'll be frozen pizza. Third and five. Blitz is on. Bell picks it up. Unloads at the 12. And it's caught. First down for the Gators by Stacy Simmons on a comeback. Simmons, who was recruited by Florida, Florida State, and Georgia Tech. Great effort.
And here comes Crane on the blitz, and Bell stepping up. The veteran right there. He doesn't get there. Great pass by Bell. And Simmons, the leading receiver. Good concentration. Super concentration. Just inside that first down marker. And I'll tell you what, Bell's been on the mark here.
Like a Frank Viola fastball. 12 for 20, 154. Late developing trap to the 10, picks up four, goes Emmett Smith. Nate Hill, number 99, on the stop.
Let's go back to the beginning of this drive when Emmett Smith went wide right, wide left, pick up early yardage, really loosened up that Auburn defense, and then couple that with Kerwin Bell and the accuracy and the play selection back and forth, his ability to scramble, the Florida offense opening up and gaining yardage.
Smith now 70 yards total rushing, 36 in the third quarter. Pulled down by Benji Rowland from behind by the jersey. The junior out of Eastman, Georgia, number 96. The most valuable player after the spring practice.
96, 6'4", 268. You're looking at it from a defensive perspective. He goes around the center, which you're not supposed to do, but because it's delay action in the backfield, Smith does not get to the line of scrimmage quick enough, and Rowland's allowed to go around the block and still get into the backfield and make the tackle. They need to hit that a little quicker, it would have been there.
Woolard at the bottom of your screen, Snead at the top on third and nine. Bell safety valves it down to the eight to Clifton Reynolds, but he'll be 4 yards shy of first down yardage. Carlo Cheatham on the stop, the junior out of Sheffield, Alabama. Well, do you go for the touchdown or do you take the field goal? I think you take the field goal.
A lot of time left. You got a quarter and a half. They need the points.
So there is the ex-Auburn Tiger again, Robert McGinty, out of the hold of Steve Ewing. We've got a 9-point game. 7:10 left to go. Auburn 15, Florida 6. Let's take time out.
You know, I can't turn on the cable.
7 to go. Don't go away. That's in the third quarter. We've got all of the fourth quarter. This game, Kevin, everything we expected.
Yeah, they got 18 in the last quarter last year. Florida did. I think that's why they went for the field goal, Jim, because they feel they could score late.
Harry Mose, number 25, is back deep. He'll get it at the three. Across the 25, near the 27, Owen Bartov on the stop. McGinty with that field goal after an 82-yard, 15-play drive that used up 7.5 minutes. Boy, those are the kinds of drives, though, Kevin, you want to come out with six.
Yeah, but the first time that Florida showed their balance, their ability to run and pass in the same drive, and that's got to mean a lot to their offense.
Reggie Ware, 36, is the fullback. Stacy Danley, he's the tailback, and Berger, the quarterback, finds Danley for a first down up at the 41-yard line.
Gators sent their inside people on the blitz. The line picked it up for Auburn, and Berger found the receiver.
And he's been spreading the receivers around. Tillman, Wright, Reeve, Danley. Danley, the redshirt freshman out of Douglas County High School, played tailback, played safety, scored 17 touchdowns his senior year for Jimmy Johnson, All-State. And Berger having a great game. Gives to the fullback on the quick hitter. Big block up front by Dunn, 79, and Floyd, 63. Gerald Dickens on the stop, the senior out of Plant City, Florida.
Dickens got the first shot. Instant recognition by number 40. He doesn't make this tackle, but he allows it to happen. He's going to hit it. Watch this hit by 40. Boom. The Ware's about 240 pounds. He gets more yardage, which is a credit to Ware. If Dickens was a step over, he'd have stopped him dead in his tracks.
Dickens, the only senior inside linebacker on the roster, has paid his dues getting a shot. Second and six. Berger will take a shot. Tight end's open. He dumps it off instead to the back out of the backfield. Stacy Danley. And that's another first down up near the 46 of the Gators. Mulberry on the hit. Florida State by 52 points. Oklahoma State by 35. Bama by 11. Kentucky, a whitewash. Memphis State by a touchdown. And Louisville maintaining that three-point lead. And your old club, Wyoming.
Weaker there.
Into traffic. May have been picked off by Oliver. A wrestling match with Tillman. Now, who's got the ball?
Boy, the Florida kids immediately thought that Oliver had the ball. Immediately. The ones closest to this play felt that Oliver had the ball, but they all had orange hats on.
Yeah, that would influence your decision.
I would hope so.
Well, some of Florida's offense is even out there. They're saying incomplete pass.
Number 18. Cut right in front. It has to be incomplete or Thielman's ball. It depends on if he has it when he hits the ground.
Well, Oliver's got it there, then drops it, and Wright just picked it off the ground. So that looked like a great call by the officials. Incomplete with 5:32 left to go. Nobody doth protest too much.
Yeah.
Delay. Danley bangs it forward in the grasp of Todd Gatlin.
I'd say it was a hole. 12 feet wide. Gatlin doesn't make that tackle. It's a 40-yard gain. Look at this hole. But folks, that is a hole. And Gatlin, open field on Ware. That's just, it's not Ware, is it?
Gatlin out of Choctawatchee High School, where the ex-Gator Bob Lyle is the coach.
How could you pronounce that?
Auburn has made their last five third-down conversions. Donaldson will try to make it the last six up near the 33-yard line. Duke Donaldson, the senior, out of Cairo, Georgia. Mulberry on the hit. First down for Auburn. Boy, one thing Auburn is not doing is getting conservative and going into a shell. They've got a 9-point lead, and they know that will not be enough against this Gator offense.
Well, plus, they're a passing offense. I don't think they'd get a yard if they went to a straight running game.
Danley inside the 30, wrestles down to the 28. Rondy Weston, broken jaw and all, has him there.
How good would he be if his jaw wasn't broken? A lot of credit should go, I think, to Pat Sullivan. They brought him in to work with the quarterbacks. They said here at Auburn that they had athletes at quarterback, but they never had quarterbacks at quarterback. And Berger, I'm really impressed with tonight. He's seen the whole field. He's picking out receivers, going to secondary receivers. A lot of that credit goes to Sullivan. He's come in, he's worked with this kid, and they're very, very close.
Looks like Rondy Weston is down. They've got that huge helmet off of him. Coaches said that he could have played a little bit better last year. Needs to relax a little bit, let himself go. Sometimes needs to be pushed. He'll be back in. Trots out under his own power. Second down and six, Auburn. Gives Berger a chance to go over to the sideline and confer. You can see the swelling and the wiring.
If you're wondering about the weld, it isn't wired. It was wired, Jim. If you're wondering about those of you that know that jaws are wired when they're broken, he has plates in his jaw, not wired.
Like an antenna inside. Oh, there goes Ware. Russell down at the 13-yard line. Oliver had him, or it was a touchdown. Reggie Ware fumbled a year ago against the Gators, making amends here tonight.
Rondy Weston is out. There's a little bit of a depth problem. Guys have been in for a long time. Linebackers blocked and turned. Nobody. Gatlin does not get old. over into the hole. He's the offside backer. And now you got a truck loose. Watch Gatlin, 48. Just never gets into the hole in front of the player.
Seven carries, 36 yards for Ware. There goes his eighth carry. Cracks it over the right side. Jeff Roth has him there. I want to talk a little bit, Kevin, about that Florida defense. 20 minutes, Auburn's offense had the ball in the first half, and except for that one scoring drive, it used 7.5 minutes by the Gators. Their defense has been out there again. When do they start getting worn out, worn down?
Well, they've been running Ware a lot in this game, and he's a big guy, lost 15 pounds to get down to 236, and they have run linebackers and pass linebackers at Florida. They have guys that are better against the pass and better against the run, and Auburn is catching the wrong people in there. They've had some injuries, and these guys are just too small, don't play the run well enough.
Motion by Wright, near side. Forward motion by Ware, off the right. Hudson, Garner, and Searles with a blocking. 66, 76, and 60. And there is the nose guard, Jeff Roth, again.
The flag, late flag, a real late flag on this.
Dick Burleson, the referee. And you'd have to guess the way Berger is pointing, it's against the Gators. Personal foul.
Yeah, it looked like it happened in the pile late after the play.
Well, we talked about Galen Hall being patient, but he's not going to be very patient much longer. 2:50 to go in the third. And if Auburn takes it in here, suddenly you're looking at a 22 or a 24-6 score.
Well, we talked about their depth problems. They've been on probation the prior 3 years to this year. They have only 75 players on scholarship. Of course, they weren't on television. They were penalized in scholarships. They have a number of walk-ons. They lost linebacker Jason Lambert to an injury. He had to quit football because of a knee. Pat Moore is out, an inside linebacker. Gatlin is in, but he missed the first four games. He may not be 100%. And this team is thin, and they are getting worn out. And Ware, at 236 pounds, is just beating him to death inside now.
First and goal from the two after the personal foul. High pro set with Ware and Danley. It's Reggie to the half-yard line. And another flag to be checked out. Thrown by the linesman from the far side. It's against the Gators.
When you're tired defensively, you do get offside. And the reason is you realize that you're losing your strength and you're being outmanned, and you try to outquick them and get a jump, and a lot of times you'll jump offside. Great defensive teams do not get offside defensively, but it will happen when you're tired. It's been a very physical drive. Ware is pounding them inside, and these guys are trying to get that extra inch, and they're leaping offside.
I want to give you a stat on Reggie Ware out of Huntsville, Alabama. He has 186 career carries, but he has 23 touchdowns. So one out of every nine times number 36 gets the football, he scores.
Well, normally, I believe he gets it down close to the goal line, so his yardage per carry is not great, but he doesn't fumble, and he's a bruiser.
Reggie, loose football, and the Gators have got it. A huge turnover for Florida. And they worked with Reggie about his hands, but that was in pass receiving with a frisbee.
Yeah, he's not been a fumbler. He's been a guy who can't catch. Great anticipation inside. See it? By the Gators, that's Charlton. Charlton gets his head right in the face of Ware.
Boy, if you're a Florida fan, Kevin, you couldn't ask for a better time for a turnover.
That was 56, Charlton with his head right in the gut of Reggie Ware knocking the ball. It was great anticipation. They knew who was going to get the ball. They made it work for him by Florida.
And Watkins, who's made two mistakes for Florida, recovered the loose football from the one. A little cross puck to the five, four tough yards for Anthony Williams.
Boy, that's a turnover there. Remember here at Auburn, if this game turns around. That's the danger of giving it to the same guy against a quality defense. They were loading up on him. Charlton coming from the outside. There's a nice statistic there. Last first six drives, net 67. Last two drives, 152. They can add another 98 here if they get in the end zone because they're starting from their 1-2 yard line.
But those stats don't mean anything if they don't get a touchdown soon. They're down by 9 points. And they've only got 2 field goals for all their drives. Emmett Smith looked like he bobbled the ball just a little bit. Cracks it across the 7. Quentin Riggins, 41, the sophomore from Montgomery, hammered him down there.
Well, I'm impressed with the Florida defense. They were backed up and being pushed back, and they really gave it everything they had. That looked like an absolute sure touchdown. And they were, and a great player getting his hat in there and knocking the ball away.
Now, do you sprint out with Kerwin Bell, or you try to isolate Smith here to the wide side of the field?
Well, I think they got to get the ball in Simmons or Smith's hands. They're the two leading receivers.
Good time for a blitz. Smith will not get the first down. Galen is patient and was very conservative. So it's a punting situation from your own end zone. Clock inside of 40 seconds in quarter number 3. Benji Rowland, 96, led the charge for Auburn.
Well, you wonder why they make that call. I'll tell you why they made it. Because they run in a draw look. Auburn should be looking for the pass. They take a drop back on the line, try to get those linemen out of position. But the Auburn people have taught these guys to look for the draw, and they're not getting the inside running game going.
And now you give the ball back to Auburn in great field position. Line drive kick. Donaldson, the wide receiver at the 43, across midfield down to the 48-yard line of the Gators. A 50-yard kick, a 7-yard return, 9 seconds left, and we'll take timeout. How about the 4 call, Kevin Colley? Did you like it?
I think I would have liked it based on their success with the draw play. They average about 8 yards a carry on that draw play alone, but they have not run well inside. You have to kind of balance the two things.
First and 10, Auburn, they lead 15-6. 9 seconds left in the third quarter. There goes Stacy Danley across the 40, close to first down yardage as time ticks down in quarter number 3. 15 minutes left in the 64th meeting in the SEC between Auburn and Florida. The Tigers on top. Welcome back to Auburn, Alabama. I'm Jim Kelly. Kevin Kiley is alongside. There is the senior quarterback, Jeff Berger. He's had the hot hand since the second snap. Quick count. Straight ahead goes Reggie Ware, who fumbled the last time he touched the ball. That was at the 1-yard line. But Auburn coming right back. There's Galen Hall over on the sideline. We talked about him being very patient, but when time runs out, sometimes impatience takes over.
Well, he's a guy who waited 18 years to be a head coach. The way he became a head coach and went 8-0, he's got patience, and that's the way to approach this game. Anything can happen.
First and 10 from the 32, sideline out. There's Stacy Danley, stopped at the 30-yard line. Second down and 8 coming up. Dickens on the stop. Well, Joe Paterno said that Galen Hall is simply the smartest football player he's ever been around at 35 years at Penn State. Now, Galen's mom, 73-year-old Grace, says, "My son is a good, quiet leader. He's not a showboat. Strong competitor, doesn't really enjoy the limelight, but he's a great leader of young men. Really turned the Florida program around."
Gators play for him.
Danley. Hammered down at the line of scrimmage. Dickens again. 2 straight stops.
Dickens is playing an excellent game. 6'1", 227 pounds from Plant City, Florida. Fifth-year senior. Jim mentioned it earlier. Guy waited a long time to get into that Florida defense, and he's making the most of it.
This is a key defensive series right now for the Gators. It's 3rd and 8. 5 defensive backs. Bartrup checks in. They have to keep out of the end zone. Blitz. Berger gets banged down at the 39-yard line. Huey Richardson, the freshman out of Atlanta, number 90, came in from his outside linebacker spot. Played on the scout team last year, redshirt out of Lakeside High School, and one of the premier linebackers in the country.
They sent everybody. Charlton here, number 56 at the top of your screen, but he's going to get him. Richardson's going to get him from the back, and I mean they sent everybody. They left 4 or 5 guys in the secondary. 6 or 7 came, and it worked.
And
and get them out of field goal range. Jarvis Williams back in. Good punt, hits at the 12. Rolls inside the 5 and is down at the 2-yard line. Boy, the importance of specialty teams, a 37-yard punt, a tight ball game. 12:45 to go. Great punt by Shulman. ESPN presentation of CFA football being brought to you by AC Delco. Stay out of trouble with AC Delco parts. And by Casio, maker of the shock-resistant, water-resistant G-Shock. It's one tough watch to beat. And while we have a second on Halloween night, all of us at ESPN certainly appreciate the Auburn band. Great performance tonight under the direction of Dr. Johnny Vincent. McGrady in at fullback. Smith at tailback. McGrady gets it. Cracks off the left side for a tough yard and a half. Well, Kevin, storyline Auburn, Alabama. It started off with three win-wild field goals. Auburn, 9 points off two Florida turnovers. Berger, a hot hand. Smith, 21 carries, 72 yards. That 100-yard century mark, that could be in jeopardy.
It is in jeopardy.
Second and 9. From the end zone, Bell needs a bunch. Fires over the middle, got a first down. Stacey Simmons. On the crossing pattern, down at the 19, and guess who's there? Unbelievable. Andre Bruce. Talk about pursuit. Black Thunder right there.
Talk about an arm. Kerwin Bell, in his own end zone, as cool as he can be. Look at the block there, the protection on Crane, and then just a rifle. Right in the middle of that zone, and Auburn covering up. But Bell, so cool standing in his end zone.
And you saw 93 flying after being pressured on the quarterback. Bell again over the middle, got Mills. Mills upended at the 43-yard line by Carlo Cheatham.
Now here's a guy who runs 4-2-8. Mills, he's the one who dropped the first pass of the game. Bell, plenty of time getting the job done by the offensive line. Mills not going to drop that one. Again, that dead zone, again, in the middle of the zone. With the speed burner, they keep contained. Florida moving.
Florida drives this half. They've started at their own 10, their own 1, their own 3. Bells hit 7 in a row. Bruce bumped out of it. Oh, my. Bell needs a block. Needs a receiver. Unloads. Caught at the 40-yard line. McGrady out of the backfield. Crane on the coverage, and I think Bell should have thrown that one out of bounds.
Willie's the one that threw that block earlier, the freshman. Boy, he's growing up in a hurry. Look at Bell. You don't need me to describe this. And Willie calling for the ball, which he didn't right there. He rolled his hand up again.
Double coverage. Said, wait a minute, throw me the ball when they're not two blue jerseys. Yeah. Second and 12. All kinds of time, but the coverage is great. So is the effort by Robert Goff. He says his hero is Jack Tatum. One of the coaches called him Robert early on. He said, no, my name is Pig. Yeah. He gave it to himself, that nickname. That's what he likes to be called, Pig Goff. Transferred out of Kansas to Auburn.
I'm sure the Florida players would accommodate him after that play. There was a receiver wide open down the left sideline, holding his hand up. Bell had a chance. He could have thrown the ball to him. He never did see him.
It was first and 10. Now it's third and 21. Wayne Williams, a junior out of Titusville, and wide out. Andre on the blitz. Bell incomplete at the 45, and Andre Bruce got there. Bell said, where's the flag?
You don't want to become predictable against a team that has that kind of talent. Andre Bruce, he's 6'6". He tips a lot of passes. This ball was deflected right over McGrady. And he's pumped. He tore Georgia Tech apart single-handedly, and he's taken over here.
McAndrew back to punt. Donaldson back to receive. Fields at the 32, and he's got some room. Up to the 37. A 5-yard return after a 37-yard punt. 9:37 to go in the game.
How does the...
9:37 to go. Will Auburn get conservative and sit on that lead, Kevin?
No, I don't think they can be conservative. Certainly not after last year when Florida came from behind, and they are a passing team.
Berger, man wide open at midfield. That's the tight end. Excuse me, that's the wideout lawyer, Tillman. Another first down for the Tigers. Well, we talk about impact players. Emmett Smith, there's what he's done rushing and receiving. Andre Bruce, he's been in the backfield all night.
Andre had his biggest game of the year last year against Florida. He had 10 tackles in the game. You do feel sometimes that you play better against some teams. If you have a good game the next year, you will have confidence.
Danley dances up to about the 43-yard line. Roth has him there. Roth has played a great game, number 96 at nose tackle. For the Gator defense, they've been out there most of the night. Congratulations to Mike Archer and his Tigers of LSU. They are now 4-0 in the SEC. Alabama looks like they're rolling the tide over Mississippi State. Arkansas State coming back. And Tulsa taking a 4-point lead. 9:18 left to go. Auburn on top by 9.
Some people take chances
for a large university with a diversity of majors and curricula. Yet Auburn tends to still be a school where close relationships are possible. You start off with students who are intellectually good and intellectually curious. And yet it's human enough and warm enough and personal enough so that students who want help and seek help get help. And that's just very unusual.
Football player, head coach at Florida, looking at a 9-point deficit as Ware cracks it over the sideline. On second and 4, it'll bring up third and short. And his counterpart, who grew up in Blythe, Georgia, near Augusta, Pat Dye. And he knows what it's like at Amen Corner, the 11th, 12th, and 13th over that hallowed ground that used to be a nursery. Well, he's got his own Amen Corner. It's coming up on the schedule, partner.
Well, Florida State scored 73 points today. And they're coming up on the 7th in Georgia and Alabama. Amen to that.
Pat Dye had the flu, but a victory tonight would make things a lot better. Danley explodes across the 30-yard line. Another first down for the Auburn Tigers. Oliver bumped him out of bounds, but that's a huge first down. 8:19 left to go.
Talked about earlier about how putting a tight end over Charlton, making him play the tight end. Here's Reeves on Charlton. Both hands, tries to cut him, but he cuts down the pursuit. There's the block, right side of your screen. And here's Danley with nobody out there. Makes it tough on that guy. Charlton is really a weak linebacker, a weak side linebacker, I mean. A guy who plays on the short side, he needs to be free. Had a little trouble getting off that block.
Danley, 5 carries, 39 yards. Ware, inside blocking by Hudson, Garner, and Searles. And Henry Brown, number 99, the senior out of Fort Myers, Florida, on the stop.
You mentioned the interior of that line, and I said earlier in the game that that might be a suspect part of this team. They might not have the strength. They started out passing, they've gone to the running game, and they've made it work against a very tired Florida defense.
Boy, they have been out there a long time. Inside of 7:50 now left to go. And the Gator defense, Kevin, they have to come up with a turnover here. You can't let Auburn score the touchdown.
They've got to blitz. They've got to come. They've just got to make something happen here and try and stuff.
Field goal would make it a 12-point game. 2 touchdowns conceivably could win it. There goes Danley. Turns the corner inside the 20. Bumped out of bounds at the 17 by Oliver again. Another Tiger first down. They're just wearing down the Gators now.
Number 60, Stacy Searles. Watch him, left side of your screen. He's the guy that hooks him. See that? He's the one who creates the corner for Danley to go all the way from the off-tackle position. Should never happen. You got to stop up, step up, meet that guy, and create a hard corner. He didn't do it.
From the 17, Reeves, the tight end, lines up on the left. Motion by Wright. Danley, look out, inside the 10. He needed to get to the 7. Blocking by Garner, 76, Searles 60, and Hudson 66. And again, that Gator defense just running out of gas.
63 and 79, watch him hold the blocks. Florida players not getting off the blocks, not getting in the pursuit. And there's always a seam when that happens. You got to hit and get off on defense. Credit to the Auburn offensive line. Dunn and Floyd, they did a nice job.
Stanley, 51 yards rushing, too short of his career high. Could break it right now. Does, will. First and goal at the 3. Rondy Weston with his broken jaw on the stop.
Offensive line again for Auburn. The left side, Floyd and Dunn and Hudson. Florida not getting off the block. See him? Dunn with nobody to block. He's running through the line looking for somebody to show up. Nobody shows up, and Wetson, broken jaw and all, comes from the backside to make the tackle.
As we mentioned, a career high for Stacy Danley as Auburn goes with two tight ends. Lee Mark Sellers, 84. Walter Reeves, 86. The Gator defense has given up just 2 touchdowns in the last 6 combined games. Ware bangs it ever closer, and a flag to be checked out.
I believe Florida lined up offsides. Again, same thing, trying to get that advantage on the goal line.
Offside, goal against Florida.
That happens when you're tired. I told you, you know, when you're tired and you line up, you almost can't back up. You know you're offsides. You don't have the energy to jump back sometimes.
Look at Rondy Weston, though. He was trying to exhort his teammates to rally. There is a very somber Galen Hall.
There's another problem for Florida because of the depth. He can't substitute. He really has a drop off when he takes his top people out. So they have to play the whole game against a passing team. They run you back and forth against patterns. You're in deep coverage all the time. You're rushing the passer. That really takes a lot out of you. Inside running game doesn't take out as much as the wide running and the passing.
If the Gators have got a goal line stand in them the rest of the season, it must be now. Ware to about the 1.5-yard line. Jeff Reuter had him there, number 47, the junior out of Phoenix, Arizona. Here's a story. Reuter, both his parents went to Iowa. He's out of Phoenix, and he ends up going to school in Florida. Talk about a recruiting job.
And he ends up starting because of Jason Lambert's knee problems. Big loss for Florida, a guy who had chronic knee problems. Reuter now playing because Lambert, unhappily, had to just retire from college football. He couldn't stand the pain anymore. He was an excellent player. If they fake in the middle of the line and come outside here to the left side, he could walk in.
Harry Moe, the freshman from Lake Wales. Field goal effort in the first half out of the hold of Brian Schulman, the putter. It's a 22-6 ball game against a Gator defense that has given up just 2 touchdowns in their last 6 games.
Not much lateral movement left in that Florida line. Here comes the offense. A lot of power at the point of attack, and Moe's just pushing it in.
The Frenchman, Harry Moe's, had 10 touchdowns for his coach, James Hale, at Lake Wales High School. This is his first at Auburn.
presentation of football has been brought to you by the U.S. Armed Forces. It's a great place to start. By Michelob Light. When the sun goes down, light up the night with Michelob Light. By Shell Oil Company. Experience the difference Shell people and Shell products make. And by GTE. GTE. Well, the Gators, Kevin, would like to dial up two touchdowns and two two-point conversions. They need 16 points for a tie. Stacy Simmons, 25, is back deep, and Chris Johnson again will kick it off for the Tigers. It is high, it is end over end, and it's Simmons at the five. Down at the 22-yard line. That last scoring drive, Kevin Kiley, 64 yards, 10 plays, used up 4 minutes and 13 seconds. But what it really did was put the knife into the heart of the Gators.
Yeah, it was a very strong drive. Credit to the offensive line of Auburn. Just a balanced drive. Everybody did their part, and they got 7, which is what they needed.
Now the Gators need 2 touchdowns and 2 two-point conversions to eke out a 22-22 tie. Complete at midfield with the gloves on goes number 82, Walter Odom, the tight end. But there's a flag in the backfield of Florida. Thrown at the 18-yard line. A 33-yard reception that may be coming back. That's been the story of the game.
Yes, it has. Mistakes. Florida, too many mistakes.
Holding against the Gators. And Galen Hall takes off the hat. He is unflappable, even in mistakes. His demeanor does not change. You know, Gil Brandt of the Cowboys, who is certainly one of the great evaluators of talent, says that there's not a better X and O's man, college coach in the country than Galen Hall. He knows how to attack defenses. He always has the calm and presence of mind to be able to think under pressure during a game. That's the ultimate compliment from the Cowboy player personnel director. From the 12, first and 20. Bell, Odom again, this time at the 22. They need to get up to the 32 for a first down.
This is exactly the position you don't want to be in if you've got a quality quarterback. Why? Because Auburn's going to tee off on him.
Was that a late hit?
No. I think his momentum was going before he threw the ball. You let go about 5 or 6 yards before you get to him. Emmett Smith, by the way, has 21 carries, 72 yards, and just under 5 minutes to get his 100.
He tries to dish it off, and it'll be intentional grounding. And Bell can't believe the call, because Anthony Williams was about 4 feet from where Bell threw the football. Now, Bell tried to sidearm it, and Williams, 36, Kevin, was there.
I don't think there's any question this is grounding. He has no chance. He's got him by the shoulders. Absolutely no chance of completing this pass. And Nate Hill and Bruce just absolutely overpowering the blocking or attempted blocking. He has no chance. He's got him by the arm, by the throwing arm. And I don't think that in his mind, Kerwin Bell thought he could complete that pass. Good call by the official.
How many third and 29 plays do you have?
Florida's had a bunch of them in this half. Auburn's defense simply overpowering Florida. Bruce is incredible. He's really impressive.
Incomplete at the 10, looking for Smith. They needed 29. That wouldn't have done it, and here comes the punting team. We have seen this year some great linebackers. If there's a better linebacker than Andre Bruce and maybe Zeke Gadsden for Pitt,
I don't know. Those two have been the best two linebackers I've seen all season. How about you?
Well, I would agree. The performance, unbelievable. And the same type of backer, too, that Lawrence Taylor type. Interesting. This guy's 6'6", 236. He can put another 40 pounds on. How's that for a frightening thought?
Snap is high. Donaldson is back deep. McAndrew's eighth punt of the night. Great field position, and here goes the Duke. Down to the 27-yard line. Well, we talked about the SEC top to bottom being maybe the toughest conference in the country. LSU has got Alabama at home next week in Death Valley, then Mississippi State.
Well, LSU does not have a loss. If they beat those two teams, they will win the SEC. Auburn, with that tie against Tennessee, Georgia, and Alabama, tough to face that even with the win tonight. Alabama at LSU with a loss, and then Auburn again. There's really no, this is really, this graphic, I think, really points up the difficulty in the schedule in the SEC. Every week you've got a test.
Florida has won the last three in this series. Auburn on top with just 4 minutes left to go and in total control. Danley, who's already set his own personal record tonight, carries again. Huey Richardson on the stop. Danley, the freshman out of Winston, Georgia, his own personal best here tonight, and he's got a great career ahead of him. And I would make friends with Andre Bruce.
Yeah. Well, I think if we go back to Gerwin Bell, given Andre Bruce's little cap and the helmet, I would say that Andre certainly made his point since then.
Walter Reeves, the tight end, lines up on the left side. Duke Donaldson motions top of your screen. Reggie Ware bangs it straight ahead, and another flag is thrown. Seeger on the stop. Holding against the Tigers, one of the few mistakes that they have made.
There is a point, Jim, in a football game where you know you've been beaten. It's a tough time in the game. That's what we're experiencing now when you watch Florida. I mean, it's a team that's been beaten physically here in the second half. I'm sure they're exhausted. They know they don't match up anymore against this team. This Auburn team that's pumped up and getting revenge. And these last 3:32 are going to be tough for a very proud Florida defense. Just physically taking over a manhandle at the late stage of this game.
And counting. Berger, who's gone the whole way except for the first snap. Reggie Slack took that. His day will come. Pat Dye said this is Jeff's game to win or lose. Danley inside the 20 to the 17. Oliver on the stop. And Lewis Oliver, number 18, has 10 solo tackles. It's been a busy night in the secondary of the Gators.
They're just killing them at the corner. Watch Brad Hatcher, number 76. Lineman, left side of your screen, turning and just sealing down the corner. You got a kick out block there, and there's nobody there for Florida. And there hasn't been most of this half. They've been running left and getting away with it here for about a quarter and a half. Auburn has.
Super freshman from Florida. In our other Florida telecast, I of course mistakenly said he was a walk-on. Kevin, he was one of the highest recruited athletes ever, and he of course is a Heisman hopeful. He's got three more years. He's one of the great backs, and that century mark definitely in jeopardy tonight, because with Florida down, they've got to go to the air attack. He won't get his seventh consecutive game 100 yards in college.
We said earlier that this possibly was the game where he would not get 100 yards. This is the best defense he has faced all year. And I think he's been introduced to the top level of college football. There it is.
He certainly was introduced to Andre Bruce. And there's a touchdown for Stacy Dantley. Blocking by Hudson, Garner, Searles Dantley now, 16 carries, 80 yards, and a touchdown.
Very little left. High formation, power inside. Look at him not getting off their blocks on the inside, just riding the linebackers out of there. Dantley going in.
And Lyle has been perfect. Dantley, the redshirt freshman out of Douglas County High School, and coach Jimmy Johnson carried for 17 touchdowns his senior year, 1,478 yards.
When a defense gets tired, they get high. And look how high all those orange hats are until Auburn puts them down on the ground. You just can't bend your legs anymore, and it's the worst thing you can do. Dantley walking in. They're walking all over Florida.
Stacy says his idol in the NFL is Eric Dickerson. Well, he looked like Eric Dickerson right there. LSU has won big tonight, so they go to 4-0 in the SEC. Auburn, no problem tonight against Florida. They will be 3-0-1. Georgia 3-1-0. Alabama 2-1-0. Tennessee 1-1-1. And Florida dips to the 500 mark.
And Auburn does not play LSU. I think we need, if you didn't see the earlier graphic, they do not meet this year.
Boy, would that set up some kind of a Sugar Bowl match if they both go undefeated?
Well, I believe they said they'd take the two highest rated teams that they could get, or the one highest rated team, to go with the SEC champion. I would love to see two SEC teams in the Sugar Bowl. Roof it, come on.
Well, we've got Sugar Bowl scouts here, scouts from the Pete Orange Hall of Fame, Gator, Florida, and Fiesta Bowl. At the 9-yard line, Simmons again. But this one is all over, but for the final stats. At the 22-yard line, that's where the Gators will start with 97 seconds left and a 23-point lead. Yep, it's Happy Halloween, and there'll be some celebrating. What was that drugstore we had the lemonade at?
Oh, don't ask me that. What was it?
The best homemade lemonade ever.
Toomer's Corner. Where they will be celebrating tonight. They say they get as much as 12,000 out there throwing toilet paper after a win. Hey, go get some. Save me a few bucks.
Andre Bruce on the blitz. Bell unloads, gets it to the 27-yard line. James Massey cracks it across the 35. Well, we'll be having dinner at Phil's Oyster Bar next week. They've just announced that it's Alabama and LSU, our primetime ESPN game. We'll be in Baton Rouge. Mike Archer and his unbeaten LSU Tigers, unbeaten in the SEC. What a job he's done. Youngest head coach. Deflected by number 39, Kurt Crane.
I have to say something about Kerwin Bell here. A guy who just keeps coming. Started out the year as a Heisman candidate. Did not have the receivers. Along comes Emmitt Smith. Takes over the spotlight. But he's played a brilliant game tonight. The passing and scrambling. He kept Florida in it for as long as he could until his defense just flat got blown out. A great, great kid.
18 of 29, partner. 221 yards. Second and 10 from his own 34. Fires deflected at the 34 by John Wiley. 29-6 is our score, and you have to go back in the record book to 1977 to find the last time Auburn has scored 29 points. They beat Florida then 29-14.
I did not figure to be that big a margin of victory, but Florida giving up, as I said, just over 9 points a game. How about the year, Auburn doing the same thing.
How about the Gators on the ground? Their season average, 229 yards, just 61 tonight. Got his man up near the 48-yard line, Bell does. That is Stacy Simmons. I think Kerwin Bell is going to be seeing blue jerseys for about three nights.
Simmons has played a good game. I think Simmons is one of those receivers early in the year was dropping passes. He's come on in this game, made a lot of good catches. Remember one on the sideline for a first down was really an excellent catch. Florida's got some life left. It is a pretty good football team.
Simmons, four catches, 58 yards. Let's go back to the very first snap for the Gators. A drop touchdown pass by Ernie Mills. Might have met a different outcome.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Ray Bruce in the backfield where he has lived. And it's picked off by Auburn. Carlos Cheatham, number 35, down at the 40-yard line, and that'll close the book. His idol is Kenny Easley. He looked like Kenny Easley. I want to tell you a story. It took, well, after the interception, Kip.
Great reaction by Cheatham. Goes right through the receiver's hands, and Cheatham catches it anyway. Tough thing to do, and then nobody shows up until he gets way down there. Watch this. That ball could have been caught, and Cheatham, self-defense, picks it off. Tough break for Bell. Another well-thrown pass. His interception rate's only 3.73% of his passes, which is very, very low.
The 44 penalty flag is down, and there's a flag to be checked out. Bell, 19 of 32, one interception and 225 yards. Going back to Carlo Cheatham out of Muscle Shoals High School in Alabama. There he is with the interception. He is so shy that it was 3 years before he went to any of the sports publicity people at Auburn and said, "My name is Carlo, not Carlos." Took him 3 years to speak up after they had listed him as Carlos.
You didn't give me a chance to say how shy was he.
Okay, Ed. And as Kevin pointed out, a gutty performance by Kerwin Bell tonight.
This guy is an all-American boy right there. And did most of his work in obscurity with Florida on probation for 3 years. A guy that didn't get on television, hadn't been to a bowl game, and his dream was the Sugar Bowl, not the high school. And it looks like his second dream is going up in smoke tonight.
He said if the Heisman happens, it happens. But his first goal was to get to New Orleans.
I think with a mature team, he would have had a heck of a chance. The players he plays with are good athletes. They're just not ready for that kind of precision.
Berger falls on the ball. 45 seconds left. So Florida gets ready for Georgia. And Auburn, well, they'll look ahead to Florida State. And Pat Dye, who grew up in Blythe, Georgia, near Augusta, used to get up before dawn to perform the chores on his farm, hitch a ride to town in a milk truck. Said that his mother and father perhaps influenced him the most. He had two brothers, Wayne and Nate. Pat told me last night he was 15 before he won his first fight. So Pat Dye could have his Tigers of Auburn headed to the Sugar Bowl in New Orleans. A 29-6 win against Florida.
I think he knew he was going to be in trouble late in the year. The effects of probation, limited scholarship, debt problems on the team, and mistakes against a very, very good Auburn team cost Florida tonight. Field position, which I don't usually think is a major factor, was definitely a death knell for Florida. They had too far to go and not enough personnel to do it, and Auburn took advantage and beat him, Jim.
A great coach talking to a great freshman. We'll take time out. The Tigers win by 23.
Announcing a dramatic breakthrough in shaving technology.
The new Remington Microscreen Ultimate shaves as close as a blade and closer than any other electric shaver, or your money back.
The Ultimate's exclusive beard lifter gets whiskers other shavers leave behind. And like all Remington Microscreen shavers, the first screen shaves incredibly close, the second even closer. Try the new Remington Ultimate now. It will shave you as close as a blade and closer than any other electric shaver, or your money back.
Player Jeff Berger, the quarterback for the Auburn Tigers. 18 of 29, 221 yards, and one touchdown, leading the Tigers to a big win against the Gators of Florida. Once again, our final score, the Tigers of Auburn 29, the Gators of Florida 6. Be sure and be with us next week as ESPN presents another CFA doubleheader at 4 o'clock. Bob and Lee from Chapel Hill, Clemson in North Carolina. At 7:30, Jim and Kevin will be in Baton Rouge, Alabama, against the unbeaten LSU Tigers. There is Jeff Berger, surrounded by controversy all week. Played a great game tonight. and Andre Bruce, number 93, known as Black Thunder, threw some lightning at the Gators as well. So, for Kevin Kiley, I'm Jim Kelly, saying so long from Auburn. 85,000, the largest crowd ever in the state of Alabama. Watch the good one. Good night, everybody.